Chapter 451, Black Armors. As the king disappeared, the prime minister muttered to himself, "So what if there is a prior engagement? It is not like they are married. These engagements can be cancelled. The prince of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom cannot just come on a fool's errand." After speaking with the Jisun Kingdom's king, the prime minister had more or less confirmed the relations between the Jisun Kingdom and the Kainhuai Kingdom. Previously, he had thought the two were close, but now he knew that there was no intimate relations between the two kingdoms, alleviating a good amount of his fears. Jian Chen's commotion at the Huoyun sect hadn't been mentioned to anyone outside the sect. If news that the patriarch of the sect had been forced out was revealed by any disciple, they would be expelled and punished severely. The Huoyun sect had to protect their status within the Jisun Kingdom and prevent the news of what happened from leaking at any costs. If someone were to find out that the fourth master of the Qingyang clan had caused such trouble at the Huoyun sect's prestige would collapse and their development would come to a standstill. At the same time, the Qingyang clan would benefit from this and their prestige would raise at the same time as the Huoyun sect plummeted. The two grand elders were not willing for this to happen at all. Jian Chen and Cheng Wuji had already returned to the Qingyang clan, but right now, only Cheng Wuji, Qingyang Ba, and Bai Yanchen knew what Jian Chen had done. They chose to remain silent on the matter, but were happy nonetheless. Who would have known that the incomparably strong Huoyun sect would be dominated by their own child? Jian Chen's military might and success was something both of his parents were extremely proud of. Afterward, Jian Chen remained within the clan and didn't walk out often, choosing to spend his days by his mother's side, talking. Because the tiger cub had still not finished absorbing the heavenly resources, the cub remained in Jian Chen's room sleeping on his bed. The tiger cub was growing at an even faster rate. Jian Chen could sense a presence flowing from the tiger cub with a strength that was at the level of a class 2 magical beast. As long as this progression continued, it would become a class 3 magical beast within several days. Within Lore City in a luxurious inn, a red-robed man around the age of 27 sat by a table and drank some wine while his eyes glanced around the place idly. One of the waiters came by with a platter of steaming magical beast meat and gently set it on the table with a bow of her head. "Honored customer, your meal is here. Is there anything else you wish for?" When it came to this red-robed youth, all of the workers within the inn knew about him. That was because this youth had already lived within the inn for a month in their best room and ate their best foods. He had plenty of money and was quite well-spoken. Sometimes, he would give gold coins as a reward, and after an entire month, the entire staff had already been given a considerable amount of money that was well worth an entire year's worth of pay. And so, every single worker in this inn considered this youth a god of wealth almost. With a wave of his hand, the waitress retreated back, allowing him to dig into his delicious meal with vigor. "Why is it that I cannot find Jian Chen? With his status and strength, he should be well known within Lore City. But why is it that when I ask around, no one has heard of Jian Chen's name before? Could it be that Jian Chen isn't his real name?" The youth spoke to himself in a low voice. He had only been in Lore City for a month. After the ending of the gathering of the mercenaries, Jian Chen had given him instructions to find him in Lore City of the Jisun Kingdom. But what area in Lore City, he didn't know. "It's time to wait then. Jian Chen should have exited the Holy Lands by now. If he comes from Mercenary City, it'll take him several months to get here if he doesn't use a space gate." The youth sighed before growing silent to dig back into his meal. At the same time, within the stronghold of the Jisun Kingdom, two middle-aged men came riding at a slow pace on top of two class 3 magical beast mounts before seeing the rubble everywhere. One of the two males was around 40 years old with a bald head. He had an excellent physique that bulged with muscles. His appearance was so noticeable, it could be considered an attack on a person. The other person looked weaker than the first and wore a cyan-colored robe. His black hair was draped over his shoulder and he had a scholarly look to him. Both of his eyes glowed with a sharp look as well. "Yun Zheng, take a look at that stronghold. That should be the Jisun Kingdom." The stronger-looking man pointed at the destroyed stronghold. Hearing this, Yun Zheng took out a map from his space belt and gave it a look before nodding. That's right. According to the map, the Jisung Kingdom is right in front of us. Seeing how the stronghold is damaged like that, they must have just had a war. There's still a bloody stench in the air. The burly man let out a sigh. After half a year of traveling, we've finally reached the Jisung Kingdom. Let's not care about it and go find a city to rest up in. I haven't had any good meat in a long time. After eating, we can take it easy as we head to Lore City. Outside of Lore City, five men of varying ages wore rich-looking robes as they walked the path. Each one of them looked rather ordinary, but the auras they exuded were anything but. They even affected the merchants and mercenaries traveling on the same road as them, so that the people subconsciously drew away from them as if they didn't dare get closer. From a distance, the walls to Lore City could already be seen. Luo Tian's hand held a gourd of wine, drinking it viciously as he walked. Then, he turned to the elder right next to him. Zhao Tian, Lore City is a first-class city with an equally large area. Where are we going to find the Imperial Advisor? Zhao Tian shook his head. The Imperial Protector wasn't clear in his instructions. Let us wait for what happens afterward to see. Ah, is the Imperial Protector truly from the Jisung Kingdom? Why is such a strong person like the Imperial Protector so unknown within the Jisung Kingdom? This is far too outrageous. King Shifan spoke questioningly. I find this strange as well. With the strength of the Imperial Protector, the entire Jisung Kingdom should know about him. Instead, he is completely unknown. This is quite strange. Dong Yi Junbai spoke. Zhao Tian looked at the others with a displeased look. That's enough. We are already on the main roads. There isn't a need to talk about such a topic. A question like this will be easily resolved later. Suddenly, the sounds of hooves could be heard trotting across the ground from behind as a large group of black-armored soldiers came storming forward on their magical beast mounts. A single trail of smoke rose up above the ground as they traversed through the area. Banners could be seen hoisted in the air, causing every single merchant and mercenary to pale. That's the black armors. Quick, get out of the way. One of the merchants cried out in shock before forcing his carriage to the side to allow the force to ride past. Then, they each looked at the army as they blew past them with looks of confusion. The black armors are the strongest force that protects the Imperial family. They rarely come out. So what's going on today for their entire force to assemble in such a frantic manner? Did something happen? Many of the mercenaries began to question. At that moment, the five Imperial advisors walking up front turned around to look at the charging black armors. Isn't that the king of the Jisung Kingdom? Why is he running in such a hurry? Could he be looking for us? Luo Tian spoke with surprise. The black armors were moving at a high speed and quickly came close to the Imperial advisors. At that moment, the leader of the black armors that was protecting the king of the Jisung Kingdom instantly realized who those five were. He immediately waved his hand and cried out, "Halt!" Instantly, the black armors stopped their charge, allowing the king time to dismount from his mount to quickly walk up to the five Imperial advisors with a warm smile and bow. This one had no idea that we would come across the honored Imperial advisors here. How coincidental. When the other black armors recognized who these experts were, they immediately bowed their heads in greeting as well. Your Majesty, seeing how rushed you are, has something happened? Dong Yi Junbai spoke with a curious look. The king let out a smile. This might be unbelievable to the honored Imperial advisors, but there is an exceptional expert within our Jisung Kingdom. Despite being so young, he has already become a Heaven Saint Master, just by himself. He was able to defeat three other Heaven Saint Masters without being damaged himself. Even this king is amazed at such a feat. Hearing this, each one of the five Imperial advisors looked at each other in surprise and amazement before Zhao Tian spoke. Your Majesty, who might this person be? He is the fourth master of the Qingyang clan, Qingyang Xiangshen. The king didn't hide anything at all and gave a bright smile in his heart. He knew that with Qingyang Xiangshen's talent, even the Imperial advisors from the Kainhuai Kingdom would wish to bring him into their friendship. With the engagement from Qingyang Xiangshen to his daughter and the connection with the Kainhuai Kingdom, The Jisung kingdom would surely profit from this. It was very possible that Qingyang Xiangshan would be able to bring the relationship between the two kingdoms to an even higher height. The fourth master of the Qingyang clan, Qingyang Xiangshan, the five imperial advisors had made sure to remember that name immediately. The five of them agreed to follow the king to the Qingyang clan. Against such a request, the king had no desire to deny them and agreed with a straightforward response. In his heart, he was overjoyed. Everything was going according to plan. Chapter 452, Revealing His Identity. Afterward, the five imperial advisors and the king of the Jisung kingdom entered Lore City, and made their way through the streets before ultimately stopping right outside the gates to the Qingyang clan. The black armors quickly cordoned the area and stood guard to protect the king. Although the five imperial advisors were here, making it impossible for harm to befall the king, the black armors still had a job to do. Standing right beside the king, the commander of the black armors, Bai Dao, stood with a stony expression as he looked at the Qingyang clan. All sorts of feelings could be felt within his heart. He didn't know what to feel exactly after being told of the news by the king. The Qingyang clan had long since heard that the king was coming. Therefore, many of the higher-ranking members had already gathered by the gates. Even Chan Yangba and Chang Wuji were standing at the very front with the elders of the clan behind them. Jian Chen and the Ats were right behind the elders. "We welcome His Majesty to our Qingyang clan. His Majesty truly does bring grace to our clan." The leader of the clan, Qing Yangba, smiled while Chang Wuji stood by his side. Grabbing the present from one of the black armor soldiers, the king handed it over to Qing Yangba and smiled. "This king hasn't been to Lore City in a long time. Since I had the time today, I decided to pay a visit. I do hope this king isn't interrupting anything." Qing Yangba let out a chuckle as he spoke a few words to the king before looking to the five imperial advisors right behind him with a startled look. Hurriedly, he bowed to them and spoke. "This one didn't think that the honored imperial advisors would come by as well. Our Qingyang clan has neglected ourselves. Please, please come in." To the five imperial advisors, Qing Yangba's face grew even more prudent without daring to be impolite. Chang Wuji bowed to the five imperial advisors as well before speaking several polite words. Then, he invited the group enthusiastically into the clan. If the five imperial advisors were to stay as guests within the Qingyang clan, it would be a tremendous honor for the Qingyang clan. Even the guards and elders of the Qingyang clan all grew excited and happy when they saw the imperial advisors come walking into the clan compound. Seeing how enthusiastic Qing Yangba and Chang Wuji were, the five imperial advisors didn't wish to look rude either. With happy smiles, they returned the polite greetings and spoke with words that were even more polite than the ones they had spoken back at the imperial palace. Afterward, the king and the other black armor soldiers around him followed the five imperial advisors past the gates. The king spoke in somewhat of a rush. "Qing Yangba, I've heard that Qingyang Xiangshan has returned. Where might he be? And if possible, would this king be able to see him? Even though he is my future son-in-law, I've yet to see him still. Ha ha ha." A faint smile could be seen on Qing Yangba's face while his heart seemed to glow brighter as he looked behind the elders to Jian Chen. "Xianger, come greet His Majesty. Perhaps it would be more appropriate to call him father-in-law." Chang Wuji suddenly spoke with a smile. Hearing this, the king was startled for a moment before quickly letting out a smile while Qing Yangba showed a great big cheerful smile on his face. The dozen elders quickly made a path through them as the white-robed, handsome Jian Chen came striding forward to bow toward the king. With a small smile, he spoke with neither a servile nor overbearing voice, "Qingyang Xiangshan pays his respect to His Majesty." Looking at Jian Chen with a serious expression, the king took notice of Jian Chen's short hair, his handsome appearance, and the perfect balance of his face that no one could complain about. All this was combined with a pale white skin that suited his appearance and caused many females to be jealous. Jian Chen was practically a walking killer of women. With his handsome and determined face, Jian Chen had clearly matured and did not look like a person that could be trifled with. "Good, very good." Seeing his future son-in-law, the king was pleased, and spoke only those three words. As a king, he had seen many people, but even he could tell that Jian Chen was by no means an everyday face. Hearing about him and seeing him in person were two different things. Now that he had met Jian Chen, his evaluation of him had instantly gone up. He is truly a dragon among men. The king sighed in admiration. By his side, Qing Yangba had a prideful smile for his son. When the five imperial advisors saw Jian Chen, they were shocked. Giving each other a look, they immediately strode forward and cupped their hands with them as they spoke. "We pay our respects to the Imperial Protector." When the five said Imperial Protector, the faces of both Qing Yangba and the King of the Jisun Kingdom instantly froze up. Blankly, they looked at how the five Imperial advisors greeted Jian Chen and stood there without speaking for a long time. All of the elders and guards of the Qing Yang clan and the black armor soldiers protecting the king had the same expression on their faces as well. Each one stared at the five Imperial advisors greeting Jian Chen with stupefied looks. "Imperial Protector, just what reason are the five Imperial advisors from the powerful Kainhuai Kingdom calling Qing Yang Xiangxian Imperial Protector?" The third Aunt Bei Yushuang spoke with surprise. In her heart, shock had completely washed over her. Jian Chen forced out a smile as he looked at Zhao Tian and the others. "I didn't think you would be able to find me so quickly." King Shefan looked around before letting out a small smile. "Honored Imperial Protector, I hope we did not cause any trouble for you." Jian Chen let out a small breath of air, but before he could speak, Qing Yangba's voice rang out first. "Xianger, just what exactly is happening?" Qing Yangba's voice trembled as he tried to hide the confusion in his words. Everyone had heard Qing Yang Xiangxian referred to as the Imperial Protector, but none of them could believe it. The five Imperial advisors had unexpectedly called his own son an Imperial Protector. Could that possibly mean that the reason why the Kainhuai Kingdom, specifically the five Imperial advisors, had traveled countless of kilometers to provide assistance to the Jisun Kingdom was because of his own son, Qing Yang Xiangxian? At that moment, Chang Wuji and the king regained their consciousness and looked at Jian Chen in shock while also waiting for his response. Jian Chen hesitated for a moment before he spoke. "Father, we should speak about this in the hall." Qing Yangba snapped out of his shock as well and quashed the tremors in his heart. Quickly, he spoke. "Yes, yes, let us go to the hall." "Your Majesty, honored Imperial advisors, please follow me inside." After speaking, the upper echelons of the Qing Yang clan, the king of the Jisun Kingdom, and the five Imperial advisors all walked into the hall. Jian Chen's mother and his three aunts originally didn't have any right to participate in this discussion. However, now that a connection between Jian Chen and the Kainhuai Kingdom had been revealed, they summoned their courage to join the conversation. Because there weren't enough chairs for everyone, the elders of the Qing Yang clan were the first to give up their seats. The elders standing to the side did not speak a single word. Instead, they stared at Jian Chen with looks of utter shock. In their minds, they couldn't help but think to what they had just heard. The five Imperial advisors had unexpectedly called the fourth master Qing Yang Xiangxian their Imperial Protector. They could hardly believe such a thing had happened. Seeing how the elders refused to sit and instead stood by the side, Jian Chen took his mother and sat her down in a chair before sitting in the seat next to her. "Xianger, just what is going on? Are you truly the Imperial Protector of the Kainhuai Kingdom?" As soon as he sat down, Qing Yangba immediately spoke with the question that was raring to escape from his mouth. "That is correct, Father. I have the status of being the Imperial Protector of the Kainhuai Kingdom." Jian Chen spoke honestly. Now that the truth was out, Jian Chen saw no need to hide the facts. Qing Yangba's body began to tremble as his face started to twitch with emotion. He turned his head to the five Imperial advisors as if looking for confirmation. The other men within the hall of the compound immediately grew silent at Jian Chen's words. Their eyes lost their light as they lost themselves in thought. The elders and Chang Wuji were especially affected as shock rode through their hearts. The mysterious Imperial Protector of the Kainhuai Kingdom had in truth been their very own clan member. The five Imperial advisors from the Kainhuai Kingdom let out smiles and nodded to verify Jian Chen's words. Among the entire group, The king of the Jisun kingdom was the most astounded and unbelieving. At first, the identity of the imperial protector of the Kainhuai kingdom had been a mystery to him. It had left him struggling to figure out what the actual connection between the Jisun and the Kainhuai kingdom was, and if it was possible to climb relations with them as if they were a tree. For the sake of thinking about such a thing, he had racked his mind trying to think of a way to no avail. He never would have thought that the result would be so theatrical. After expending so much effort, the imperial protector he wanted to curry favor with was actually his very own son-in-law. With such a result, the king of the Jisun kingdom didn't know whether to laugh or cry. "Dear son-in-law, you have surprised your entire family." The king forced a small smile on his face, but knowing that Jian Chen was the imperial protector caused him to be incredibly happy. He also started to speak to him with a different tone. Chang Wuji let out a sigh before speaking gratefully to Jian Chen. "Fourth master, this one had no idea that you had such an important status. Our Qingyang clan will definitely shine brighter because of you." Now that Jian Chen's identity had been revealed to the entire upper echelons of the Qingyang clan, everyone looked at Jian Chen in a new light. Being the imperial protector of the Kainhuai kingdom was more than enough to completely quash a king of a small kingdom like the Jisun kingdom. Chapter 453, Child of the Bai Clan. Everyone began to talk to each other after learning of such information. Now that the five imperial advisors knew the true identity of the imperial protector, they began to treat the Qingyang clan with a politeness unlike the previous noble demeanor they had used before. The five of them had an attitude that made the entire Qingyang clan feel honored, causing the clan members' faces to light up as an indicator of their feelings. Because of their connection to Jian Chen, the Qingyang clan instantly leaped over the dragon's gate and transformed into the mighty dragon. The king of the Jisun kingdom was now the lowest ranking group in terms of power among the people present. However, the king paid no attention to the ranking at all and was instead very happy. He could swear that in his entire life, he had never been as happy as he was now. Everyone continued to speak for some time before a banquet was prepared. Afterward, Qingyang Ba invited everyone to a delicious meal. "Xianger, follow your father now." Qingyang Ba began to pull at Jian Chen's hands as they walked out. Jian Chen could sense that his father's hands were shaking a little. After the banquet had been prepared in the spacious hall, the most outstanding maids gathered and began to prepare several seats around the tables. The five imperial advisors from the Kainhuai kingdom, the king of the Jisun kingdom, the leader of the Qingyang clan, Chang Wuji, Jian Chen and his mother Bai Yunchen were all seated at the same table. This arrangement had been formed after a discussion between the high-ranking elders of the Qingyang clan. Although Qingyang Ba and Bai Yunchen were not at the very top of the hierarchy, because of their outstanding son, they were able to hold the same amount of power now that their statuses had been elevated. As for Chang Wuji, despite being a housekeeper for the Qingyang clan, he had a special status within the clan. He was fully deserving of having the right to sit at this banquet with the high-ranking elders of the clan. Xianger has profited from such a disaster, it would seem. When he was forced out of his home 6 years ago at the age of 15, I never would have thought that Xianger would grow so rapidly and by such an unbelievable amount. Qingyang Ba sighed in admiration at the table. Quite right, my son-in-law is quite talented. A talent that has never been seen before. The king spouted. Hearing what the two of them said, the five imperial advisors looked at each other in shock. Although Jian Chen was young, they had all thought that Jian Chen's true age was at the very least older than what his appearance portrayed. After all, the appearance of a person was not a true way to determine a person's age. After hearing what Qingyang Ba said, the five of them realized that Jian Chen was truly younger than they thought. He was only 21 years old, a heaven saint master at the age of 21. At such a thought, Zhao Tian's heart was overwhelmed with shock. Originally, he had speculated that Jian Chen was 50 years old at the most, and 30 years old at the very least. Now that they all knew Jian Chen's true age, they were completely mute with shock. Being a heaven saint master at the age of 21 was something that had never been done before. The last outstanding genius, over the entire history of the Tianyu on continent, had been 30 years old at the very least when he had become a Heaven Saint Master. Even more surprising, that very same genius later on became a Saint King. The five imperial advisors made resolutions within their hearts. They would without fail try their best to curry favor with the youngest imperial protector within the history of the Kainhuai Kingdom and try to establish deep friendships with him. In their hearts, they knew that this young imperial protector would at the very least become an entity that would step into the realm of the Saint King. Even after the feast ended, nobody left. Instead, they gathered back in the giant hall of the Qingyang clan, where they began to converse once more. It was only at night that the entire group split ways. In private, the king of the Jisung Kingdom seeked out Qingyang Ba and Bai Yunshan. "My dear relatives, now that the war is finally over, this king still has many things to do. So, I must take my leave tomorrow morning. I sincerely hope that you will be able to visit the palace with me and discuss the engagement between my daughter and Xiangshan. Now that they are both older, it is time to manage the marriage." "Ha ha, of course, Your Majesty. Please do not worry. Once the Qingyang clan calms down, I will immediately bring Xiangshan to the palace. I hope this will not trouble Your Majesty." Qingyang Ba laughed. Although his son's identity was vastly different, Qingyang Ba himself still approved of such a marriage. One reason was because he wanted to reassure the king, and the other reason was because he approved of the princess. Qingyang Ba had seen the princess before and could only speak of her with admiration. The princess was truly an outstanding young lady. "Ha ha, what kind of talk is that? This king would be happy to receive you. It is no bother at all." The king boomed with laughter. With that, the joyous mood receded as he cleared his throat and left. After the king left, Qingyang Ba and Bai Yunshan walked to Jian Chen's room only to discover that the five imperial advisors were already inside Jian Chen's room. Qingyang Ba and his wife spoke several words of greeting to the imperial advisors before turning to Jian Chen. "Xiangshan, rest up for tonight. Tomorrow morning, we leave for the imperial palace."
"Yes, father,"
Jian Chen replied. This was within his expectations, since his identity as an imperial protector of the Kainhuai Kingdom had been revealed. It would be abnormal if the king of the Jisung Kingdom didn't try to rope the Qingyang clan into his influence as soon as possible. After thinking about his own identity, Jian Chen knew that the Jisung Kingdom would definitely rise in power thanks to the Kainhuai Kingdom. No matter what, the Jisung Kingdom was his homeland, and where the Qingyang clan had laid down its roots. As the child of the Qingyang clan, this was something he should do. Qingyang Ba and Bai Yunshan wanted to speak a little more with Jian Chen, but when they saw the five imperial advisors, they had no other choice but to leave. After Qingyang Ba and Bai Yunshan left, Jian Chen let out a deep sigh before sitting back down. "Tomorrow morning I will be back at the Imperial Palace. You five should remain here for a few days."
"Yes,
honored Imperial Protector," Zhao Tian gave a response. Unbeknownst to Jian Chen, Zhao Tian's attitude toward him had become even more respectful than before. If one were to exclude his terrifying potential, Jian Chen would still be able to fight the five of them by himself with his strength right now. As soon as the five imperial left, one of the maids waiting outside came into the room. "Fourth master, the fourth lady and clan leader wish to speak with you in the hall."
"I understand, you may go,"
Jian Chen replied.
"As you wish."
The maid withdrew. Walking up to his bed, Jian Chen looked at the peacefully sleeping white tiger cub on his pillow for a moment before leaving his room to speak with his parents. It was already night outside, but the Qingyang clan was still lit with fire, and black armored soldiers could be seen patrolling around the clan compound with icy looks. Not only were the regular sentries of the Qingyang clan standing guard, but there were also the black armors which were in charge of protecting the king. When Jian Chen entered the hall, he didn't have to worry about the activity that was normally seen in the daytime. There were only three people within the hall. Two of them were his parents, while the third person was a middle-aged man wearing black armor. He recognized this middle-aged man sitting across from Bai Yunshan and Qingyang Ba. It was his uncle, Bai Dao. "Xiangshan, come greet your uncle."
Bai Yunchen told Jian Chen as Bai Dao turned to look at Jian Chen with a happy expression. Jian Chen strode forward quickly before replying, "Hello, uncle." Bai Dao stood up from his stool with a bright smile. "Ha ha, excellent. It is no wonder you are the pride of our Bai clan." As he spoke, Bai Dao strode toward Jian Chen before quickly striking at Jian Chen's chest like lightning. Wind attributed Saint Force gathered in his fist before exploding like a strong gale from the force of his fist. Bai Dao's strike had been very sudden without any premonition. Combined with his strength as an Earth Saint Master, even Qing Yangba hadn't seen the attack coming. Jian Chen's lips curled into a faint smile as he began to gather all of the energy of the world instantly in his palm. Then, he met Bai Dao's attack straight on with a graceful swing of his palm. As the two sides collided, a muffled sound could be heard from the contact. However, the excellent control of energy from both sides made it so no energy shockwave exploded outward. Deng deng deng. After the fist and palm had made contact, Bai Dao's legs were forced back several steps as he attempted to steady himself. With yet another smile on his face, he spoke, "You can truly control the energy of the world, Xiangshen. You've truly stepped into the realm of the Heaven Saint Masters. It is no wonder that you are the Imperial Protector of the Kainhuai Kingdom. Brother, do you believe me now?" Bai Yunchen spoke with a pleased look on her face. Her own son held such a high achievement, making her feel extremely proud. "I believe. I definitely believe now, ha ha ha." Bai Dao laughed from his happiness. His eyes shimmered with a small layer of water that quickly disappeared as fast as it had appeared, meaning no one spotted it. Qing Yangba stood up from his stool and smiled. "Bai Dao, you and your sister haven't met for 6 years. Why don't you two chat for now? I need to arrange several things, so Xianger, why don't you sit here with your uncle and mother?" Qing Yangba spoke before leaving. Very quickly, Bai Dao calmed himself and looked at his nephew with a complicated look. A 21-year-old Heaven Saint Master, how unbelievable. Who would have known that even after the destruction of our Bai clan such an outstanding child would appear? Bai Dao sighed as his face slowly grew more and more serious. Looking at Jian Chen, his next words were more earnest. "Xiangshen, your uncle knows that you are different than you were in the past, and your uncle wants you to remember. Not only do you possess the blood of the Qing Yang clan through your veins, but you also contain the blood of our Bai clan. The grievances of our Bai clan all rest with you." Bai Yunchen's eyebrows narrowed together as she gave a critical look to Bai Dao and spoke with dissatisfaction. "Brother, Xianger is still too young. Why must you speak of such matters now?" "Xianger has only just returned from the bitter outer world and finally made his way back home. You needn't push even more worries onto Xianger now." "Mother, uncle is right. I am not only the child of the Qing Yang clan, but the Bai clan as well. Wait until I have enough strength. I will definitely take revenge for the Bai clan." Jian Chen answered in a serious manner. Chapter 454, The Grand Princess. "Xianger, you don't need to decide on what to do for our Bai clan just yet. Let that wait for later." Bai Yunchen spoke with concern. Despite her son being the Imperial Protector for the Kainhuai Kingdom, the enemies of the Bai clan were far from weak, and their identities today were still unclear. If the patriarch of the Bai clan was a saint ruler and still couldn't resolve the matter, how would her own son be able to? At least for right now, it was impossible. "Xiangshen, listen to your mother. You only need to remember our enemies. Revenge can wait for later. We haven't any idea on who the enemies are. Perhaps our ancestors only knew a little about them as well." Bai Dao spoke in a low whisper, but as he spoke of the past, there was a pained look on his face. Bai Dao calmed himself down and continued, "Even though our Bai clan had 4 Heaven Saint Masters, they all fell. Even our Saint Ruler Patriarch's current status is unknown. Finding out whether he is alive or not is our highest priority. But we still do not know where the Patriarch is located if he is still alive." Bai Yunchen spoke with concern. "A Saint Ruler would not die easily. With Xiangshen's talent, I believe that he will sooner or later cross over into the same realm. That will make looking for the Patriarch easier." Bai Dao looked to Jian Chen. "Xiangshen, I hope that you will be mindful and listen for news about our Bai clan's patriarch. N, I will. Jian Chen nodded. Jian Chen, his mother, and his uncle began to chat in the hall afterward before much time had passed. The three people there split paths and returned to their rooms to rest. The night quickly went by. The next morning Jian Chen walked out with the tiger cub in his hands. After eating breakfast with everyone, he left the Qingyang clan with Qingyang Ba, Bai Yunshan, the king and his black armors. The five imperial advisors remained behind within the Qingyang clan and were provided for with warm hospitality. The reason Jian Chen had them stay within the clan compound was a selfish one. He wanted his clan to gain some prestige for having the imperial advisors with them. After several hours of traveling, everyone finally arrived back at the imperial palace by night. The king brought Jian Chen and his parents to their own personal palace rooms where they rested in. While there, several maids attended to them before leaving in a hurry. Not long after the king left, a young person over the age of 20 and an elder could be seen having a discussion with each other in a grand receiving room. At this moment, a middle-aged man came rushing in before kneeling before the youth and elder. A report for the second prince and prime minister Che. The king of the Joseon kingdom has returned to the palace and brought with him three people of unusual status. Hearing this, the prime minister narrowed his eyes and asked, "Were you able to hear who these three people are, prime minister?" This humble servant was able to hear it clearly. All three of them are from the Qingyang clan. Within the Joseon kingdom, they hold a decisive amount of power. The man spoke. A spark of light could be seen in the prime minister's eyes as he spoke. "You may leave. Be sure to take note of every action they take." "Yes, prime minister." The man quickly left the room. The prime minister immersed himself in thought as he muttered, "The Qingyang clan, so they are from that clan? I heard a few years back, the king of the Joseon kingdom engaged his daughter to a person named Qingyang Xiangshan, the fourth master of the Qingyang clan. Yesterday, the king refused a marriage between our two kingdoms, and today, he brings the Qingyang clan to the imperial palace." "Haha, the meaning of this doesn't even need to be said." The second prince had a dangerous gleam in his eyes as he slowly drank his cup of tea. With a neither calm or angry voice, he spoke, "This king doesn't know how to tell bad from good. Our heavenly eagle kingdom has already offered a union between our two kingdoms, but instead of cherishing such an opportunity, he has slighted us in public." "Hmph," the prime minister spoke with a laugh, "calm your anger, second prince. The marriage was something that his majesty ordered me to complete. This old servant will surely arrange for it to happen. The relation between the Qinhuang and the Joseon kingdom is definitely not as intimate as we initially thought. There is no need to worry." Hearing this, the second prince revealed a smile on his face. "Then I'll be troubling the prime minister for your help." The prime minister's hand stroked his beard as he looked at the second prince with a smile. "Has the second prince been tempted by the princess?" The second prince nodded his head. "Her reputation precedes her. The princess truly is an excellent individual. Not only is her talent at cultivation as strong as mine, she is also exceedingly beautiful. The air she carries about her is quite different than other women. Like a needle in the haystack, she is beautiful and elegant, like a fairy released into the human world." The prime minister smirked. His elderly eyes watched how moved the second prince had become, because of the princess. At the same time, within a red silk-laced room in the palace, a single black-haired young lady could be seen sitting at her dressing table. Both of her arms were machine-like as she combed her own long hair. Her slender white fingers held the wooden comb and made the combing motions gracefully and naturally. She wore a black and white changsam that added a sense of purity to her beauty. Her eyes gleamed with a dark look that seemed as if they were concealing an ability to captivate any man that looked at her. "Yue, may your father enter?" The gentle voice of a man could be heard outside her door. "Father, you may enter." The seated lady spoke gently. The door opened, revealing the king of the Joseon kingdom, who came striding into the room. When he saw his daughter combing her hair, he let a small sigh escape his lips. "Yue, your father understands your feelings, but your father is also the ruler of a kingdom, meaning there are situations where even I cannot move freely. Father, your daughter understands. From the day I was born into royalty, Your daughter lost the ability to live her own life. The daughter's expression had a downcast look to it. Yor, please do not be so sad. Your father truly loves you. How could your father bear to let you feel anguish? Yor is far too outstanding. So there is only one man in your father's mind that suits you. Yor, hurry and get dressed. We must go see your future husband, Qingyang Xiangshen of the Qingyang clan. Qingyang Xiangshen? Is it not the prince of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom? The girl asked in confusion. The Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. The king spoke with a low nagging voice and his eyes revealed a disdainful look. How could the prince of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom suit my Yor? Yor, you may not know of this, but as things stands now, it is time to tell you. The king stopped speaking for a moment as he drew closer to Yor. He looked at the copper mirror that reflected the beauty that was his daughter. With a smile, he spoke. Yor, when you were staying at Kargath Academy in the past, I believe you met Qingyang Xiangshen. After a few years, Qingyang Xiangshen is now a person of many achievements and has far exceeded the expectations your father had. Did you know? Qingyang Xiangshen is 21 years old, but he has already become a Heaven Saint Master. Furthermore, he was able to defeat three of the Heaven Saint Masters of the Huayun sect by himself. Yor's eyes regained some semblance of vigor as her face betrayed a look of shock. She thought about how a 21-year-old was a Heaven Saint Master. Next, the king followed up on his own words. That's not all, Yor. Do you know why the imperial advisors of the Kainhuai Kingdom came to the assistance of Argisan Kingdom all of a sudden? At a loss, Yor shook her head. This was completely because of Qingyang Xiangshen, for he is also the imperial protector of the Kainhuai Kingdom. Those five imperial advisors of the Kainhuai Kingdom obeyed Qingyang Xiangshen's command to help Argisan Kingdom. As he spoke, the king of the Jisun Kingdom couldn't help but reveal some excitement in his voice as he himself grew excited. This piece of information caused no small amount of shock to Yor. As she digested the words, Yor's eyes began to widen as her cherry red lips dropped down to form a no shape in utter disbelief. After a long moment, Yor finally regained her spirit and turned to look in shock at the king. Hiding her mouth behind her hands, she asked, "How? How is that possible? Father, are you deceiving your daughter?" The king laughed. "Yor, do you think your father would play such a trick on you?" "Yor, it's time for you to get dressed. In a moment, I will be meeting with Qingyang Xiangshen." The Qingyang clan right now is a clan that Argisan Kingdom should remember to curry favor with. In the future, our kingdom will be relying on them. Ha ha ha, I never would have thought that the Imperial Protector would unexpectedly be the fourth master of the Qingyang clan. How shocking. This one is named Yi Ming, but if the Imperial Protector would be happy, please just call me by my name instead of my title. Within the palace, a white-robed figure laughed out loud and didn't bother to hide the joyous look on his face. This elder was the Heaven Saint Master in charge of protecting the Jisun Kingdom, but he had once seen Jian Chen at the Eastern Stronghold during the war. Jian Chen nodded his head with a smile on his face, but didn't speak a word. "Honored Imperial Protector, I've heard that you were once a student of Kargath Academy." The headmaster, Kafir, is already on his way here after hearing the news. "I believe that he'll be here soon. Wait until he hears that the Imperial Protector was actually a past student of Kargath Academy. I wonder what expression he'll have. Ha 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 ha." Yi Ming laughed. "Ha ha, I predict that he will be far too stunned to say a word." After Yi Ming spoke, another voice came out from behind them abruptly. Turning around, the two could see the king himself and a beautifully dressed, all in white, Yor right behind him. Her eyes had a resplendent glow to them as she looked curiously at the three people from the Qingyang clan before ultimately glancing upon Jian Chen's face. "My dear son-in-law, this is my daughter, the Grand Princess, Yu Yu." This name was personally picked out for her by her mother. As they entered the room, the king introduced his daughters straight away, but when he mentioned Yu Yu's mother, his face showed a glint of sadness. Chapter 455, Rescinding the Engagement. Jian Chen stood up from his chair and looked at Yu Yu with tranquil eyes and a smile. I pay my respects to the Grand Princess. The princess was wearing a white qingpao and stood quietly behind the king. Her long, beautiful, black hair that usually cascaded down to her waist was tied up to her head in a delicate fashion. Combined with her beautiful looks, which were capable of felling a country, her appearance had the ability to steal a man's soul. The princess didn't speak a word or return a bow and instead looked at Jian Chen curiously. Her eyes twinkled in the light, giving her the appearance of a wise person. Laughing, the king spoke, "My dear son-in-law, this must be the first time you have came to my imperial palace. Allow my Yue to show you around the place." Not even waiting for Jian Chen to respond, the king gave a look to the princess behind him. Understanding the meaning in his stare, the princess spoke gently, "Lord Qingying Xiangshen, if you would please follow me." Her voice was so soft and gentle that everyone who heard her felt themselves at peace. "Then I will trouble the princess." Jian Chen smiled as he walked forward. There were still some things he wished to speak with the princess about. Seeing him leisurely walk out with the princess, Qing Yingba and Bai Yunshen let faint smiles appear on their faces. Having the princess as a daughter was something they were both extremely satisfied with. Within the Jisun Kingdom, aside from the princess, they hadn't been able to find any other woman capable of fitting with their son. Even the king had a joyous smile on his face as he sat down next to Yi Ming and faced Qing Yingba and Bai Yunshen. "My dear family, nephew Xiangshen and my daughter Yue aren't young anymore. It seems to me that it is best to take care of the matters of marriage straight away." The king laughed, hoping that they could continue the marriage as quickly as possible. Qing Yingba and Bai Yunshen looked at each other for a brief moment before Bai Yunshen answered, "Your Majesty, we wholly agree to the marriage of Xiangshen to the princess. However, Xiangshen has grown old as well to become old enough to handle his own responsibilities. There are some matters we dare not meddle in, so I propose that we wait for Xiangshen to see what his opinion is." Hearing this, there was a glint of disappointment in the king's eyes, but he agreed with Bai Yunshen's thoughts. In the imperial palace, a single guard could be seen walking into the quarters of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom's envoys. Cupping his hands, he spoke, "A report for the second prince and the prime minister. The king of the Jisun Kingdom has brought the princess out." She and another male around the age of 20 were seen walking toward the imperial garden. "You may leave." The prime minister waved his hand for the guard to leave before furrowing his eyebrows together. There was a cold glint in the second prince's eyes as his face grew dark. "That youth must be Qingying Xiangshen. That king has refused our toast, and now he'll drink to his defeat. I personally came all the way here just to be treated in such an absurd way?" "Ridiculous." Even the prime minister let out a short snort. It would appear that the king of the Jisun Kingdom is determined to marry the princess to the Qingying clan. HMPH, it is time to find the king himself for an answer. With that, the prime minister flicked his sleeves with a furious expression. After the prime minister left, the second prince thought for a moment before snorting, "Qingying Xiangshen, let this prince see just what right you have. I am a man you cannot even touch." With that, the second prince left the place to walk toward the imperial garden with several other people from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. Jian Chen walked alongside the princess as they strolled around the palace before quickly coming into a sea of flowers. This was a world full of fresh flowers of all kinds and all sorts of colors arranged in a beautiful pattern. A sweet fragrance wafted into the air, allowing everyone to feel comforted with each breath. On the way, the two hadn't spoken a single word, but it was evident that the princess truly loved this area. As she walked alongside the flowers without a leisurely pace, her face revealed a gentle smile as she looked at the many beautiful flowers. "This is the biggest flower garden within the entire Jisun Kingdom. I enjoy this place, and if I am within the palace, I will always find myself looking at these beautiful flowers. I planted these flowers myself when I was young." The princess smiled as she spoke with a voice similar to a skylark in melody. Her snow-white qingpao combined with her beautiful looks made her resemble a fairy as she stood in the middle of the flowers. Jian Chen looked at the beautiful face of the princess for a moment before speaking, "Princess, have we met before?" He had been waiting to ask this question for a very long time. Hearing this, The princess' eyes turned away from the flowers and back toward Jian Chen before smiling. "My name is Yu Yu, Qingyang Xiangshen. Do you remember it?" An image suddenly flashed in Jian Chen's mind as he realized just who she was. "So it's you? We met many years ago at Kargath Academy. No wonder I felt that the princess looked familiar to me." The princess couldn't help but think back to when she had met Qingyang Xiangshen for the very first time, several years ago in the library of Kargath Academy. His thirst and enthrallment for knowledge had left a deep impression on her. And now, after several years, the tiny saint had suddenly transformed to become one of the strongest individuals on the Tianyuan continent. The entire Jisung kingdom, which was on the verge of destruction, had in fact been saved by this one individual, causing the princess to feel astounded. Yet, at the same time, she was left in disbelief. Looking at the handsome face of Qingyang Xiangshen, the princess hesitated for a moment before speaking. "Qingyang Xiangshen, I heard from my father that you are a heaven saint master. Would it be possible for you to allow me to experience what it is like to fly?" Jian Chen hesitated briefly before ultimately nodding his head with a smile. "Princess, prepare yourself then." With that, Jian Chen's right hand gently grasped the princess's arm. Despite her clothes serving as a barrier between his hand and her arm, Jian Chen could feel her gentle yet flexible skin underneath. Her arm was very minute and soft. Jian Chen's hand could fully wrap around it despite his hands not being too big. The very moment Jian Chen touched her arm, the princess revealed a frantic expression on her face. Ever since she was young, no other male had touched her besides her father. Without even waiting for her to react, a layer of the wind element enveloped her entire body and levitated her body from the ground. She began to slowly float into the air. Jian Chen's expression was very calm and his eyes were as tranquil as water. He slowly brought the princess into the air and up toward the sky. Soon enough, the princess calmed herself as the fresh feeling of flight captured her heart. Her face grew curious and happy as she looked down at the slowly shrinking palace below her. "Is this what it's like to fly? This is like a bird flying through the air freely. How envious I am of their experience." The princess's face could not hide the admiration she felt. "The princess has talent. As long as you continue to work hard, you will one day step into the realm of the Heaven Saint Masters." Jian Chen laughed. The princess truly did have such talent. At her current age, she was already at the Saint Master realm. The two quickly descended back to the ground in the center of the flower garden. The look the princess gave to Jian Chen now was completely different than the one from before. Seeing the beautiful face of the princess, Jian Chen hesitated for a moment before speaking. "Princess, Qingyang Xiangshen. Call me Yuer. That is what my father and uncle Yi Ming call me." As Jian Chen opened his mouth, it was closed shut by Yuer. Shortly after she spoke, her face grew a little red. "Then I shall do that." Jian Chen didn't argue. "Princess Yu Yu, there is still a matter I wish to discuss with you." The princess remained quiet as her bright eyes continued to stare straight at Jian Chen. Continuing, Jian Chen spoke. "Princess Yu Yu, the marriage between the two of us has never been agreed to by either of us. Our parents may have agreed, but the way this marriage was proposed is something I am actually against. In the past, I hadn't the power to do anything about it, and so I accepted it in silence. But it is different now. I have the power now." With that, Jian Chen stopped speaking for a moment. Although he hadn't been completely straightforward, the intelligent Yu Yu could understand where Jian Chen was going with this. The princess went silent for a moment as her eyes stared at the Go board on a nearby table. After a while, she spoke. "Qingyang Xiangshen, do you wish to rescind our engagement?" "Princess Yu Yu, I believe that even you are against how this marriage was carried out. If you agree, I will immediately ask the king to annul the marriage. I know why your father did such a thing. But you needn't worry. I am a citizen of the Jisung Kingdom. This is my home, and I will definitely protect my home." Jian Chen spoke calmly. In the past, he had been completely against this marriage. However, at the time he didn't have any power, he couldn't do anything about it. Now, the situation was different from the past. The princess was silent for a moment, but her heart was anything but calm. Hearing Jian Chen's wish to rescind the engagement caused her heart to feel a stinging pain of disappointment. It was as if she had lost something extremely important. Chapter 456, Threat of the Second Prince. Back when she was attending Kargath Academy, when she had heard that her father had already confirmed an engagement between her and someone else, the princess had been extremely against such a proposal. She had even gone to visit her father in person several times to try and repeal it, but all her attempts had resulted in failure. But after she had grown up, the princess had gradually came to understand the situation. Right now, the Jisung Kingdom could be considered to be a developing kingdom. And although she was a princess of a pampered status, there were many things she did not have the freedom to do independently. For example, she didn't even have any margin of choice regarding an important matter like lifelong marriage, which related to her future happiness. Thus, she was born as a victim, to be sacrificed for the well-being of her kingdom. Such a fate like this had only been gradually accepted by her as time went on. Initially, when she had first heard of the king's proposal of marriage between Jian Chen and her, she had been against it. But since the moment she'd hear of Jian Chen's achievements and saw his appearance, her heart had gradually accepted him. After all, Jian Chen was handsome and talented. If he was able to become a Heaven Saint Master at the age of 21, his future potential was practically unlimited. Not only that, but he was also an imperial protector for the Kainhuai Kingdom and was not arrogant despite holding such a status. In fact, he was rather amiable. After being enshrouded with so many glorious achievements, the princess' image of Jian Chen had begun to change for the better. She could even say that Jian Chen was a natural-born slayer of the hearts of women, the knight in shining armor they dreamed of. Thus, the princess had secretly felt delighted at this marriage before because of Jian Chen's excellent qualities. Even if she were to survey the entire continent, it would be hard to find a man that would be able to measure up to Jian Chen. Moreover, Jian Chen's particularly strong amount of strength and special status were also extremely important to the princess. The thought of having such an outstanding person as her future husband stirred excitement in her heart. But at this moment, Jian Chen actually took the initiative to suggest dissolving the marriage. This made the princess feel extremely disappointed. Although only a very short amount of time had passed and the princess couldn't say she was absolutely smitten with Jian Chen, he had at the very least captured her affections. After a long while of silence between the two, the princess finally broke the odd silence with a question. "Qing Ying Xiangshan, could you please tell me, why is it that you wish to rescind the marriage? Could it be your heart is already fixated with someone else?" Jian Chen shook his head. "Princess, you must have heard about what happened to me back then. I was forced to leave my Qing Yang clan for many years, and despite surviving these harsh conditions, I have made many enemies. They are very strong and are perhaps enemies that I cannot face off against as I stand today. Furthermore, there'll be an even more serious matter in the not-so-distant future. The final results are outside my range of anticipation, but I know that I must dedicate myself to improving my strength so that I will be able to avoid any possible calamity. Thus, I do not wish to waste time having any personal considerations with a woman." Hearing Jian Chen explain his reasoning, the princess let out a breath in relief before smiling at Jian Chen's handsome yet determined face. "Qing Ying Xiangshan, it is no wonder that you were able to reach your current stage in such a short amount of time. Judging by how hard you work at cultivating, you must have suffered a lot these past few years." Hearing her speak those words caused Jian Chen to inwardly sigh. In the past few years, he had truly suffered many hardships and paid heavy prices. Not only had he walked the line between life and death multiple times, he had even truly died at one point. The current achievements he held today were by no means a coincidence. "Princess, I hope that you can understand. I do not wish to have a relationship at the moment. I only wish to improve my own strength to be able to deal with the future," Jian Chen replied. He thought about the Shi family and the Jiaid clan, Both of these clans had saint rulers within their ranks. They were the people who really frightened Jian Chen. There was also the Yangji sect of the Qiangan kingdom. The patriarch had said something about guardian clans. This had also somewhat concerned Jian Chen. They shouldn't be that major of a faction. But the patriarch's words had caused Jian Chen to infer several things, and so, he started to fear that the guardian clans were far stronger than he had initially thought. Then there was also the matter with the tiger cub. Jian Chen had taken Elder Ziyu's words to heart. Perhaps the white tiger cub had already caused a stir within the continent. The Gilligan clan had already been established as an enemy of the white tiger cub and would chase after it until either side dies. With the cub being a heavenly tiger god, the Gilligan clan would be extremely adamant on having it die before it could grow old, since the cub's complete growth would spell destruction for the Gilligan clan. Right now, what made Jian Chen worry the most was that the king of the Gilligan clan would not follow the agreement it had made with the humans and would leave Cross Mountains in order to personally find and kill the tiger cub. This king was a terrifying existence that could easily kill a saint ruler. So Jian Chen didn't dare face against the king of the Gilligan clan by himself without sufficient strength. Hesitating for a moment, the princess spoke, "Qing Ying Xiangshen, that year my father had personally made the proposal. But now that you wish to rescind this marriage, have you thought about the honor of our imperial palace?" Seeing Jian Chen grow silent, the princess hesitated for a moment before finally thinking of a solution. After a brief moment, she finally found the right words to speak. "How about this, you and I will go to my father and ask that the wedding be postponed for a later date. If we do that, Princess Yu will be." Jian Chen looked a little embarrassed. If they were to do this, it would squander the princess' youth. Right now he had only wished to improve his own strength. He had never thought about such a life-changing event like marriage. The princess let out a sigh in relief. After coming to a conclusion like this, her heart still felt a little helpless. If this were several years ago, she would have agreed to Jian Chen's suggestion of cancelling the marriage without any hesitation. But now, princess, I didn't think that I would come across you here. What a coincidence." Suddenly, a cheerful voice could be heard as a smiling youth approached them from far away. His age wasn't all that different from Jian Chen's and he was also quite handsome himself. However, he had a scholarly look to him that made him look weak, which was a huge contrast to the determined look of Jian Chen. Right behind this youth were two guards around the age of 50 with steady faces and fierce eyes. "That's the second prince of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom," the princess whispered to Jian Chen. Jian Chen nodded his head slightly as his eyes hovered onto the second prince of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom before quickly losing interest and looking around at the beautiful and colorful flowers appreciatively. The second prince wore a luxurious robe with a folding fan held in his hand. He approached them with an elegant stride. Without even waiting for a greeting from either of the two, he sat down on the stool by the stone table without sparing Jian Chen a glance. His face held a splendid smile as he spoke to the princess. "I never would have imagined that I would be able to come across the princess while on a simple stroll. It would appear that the princess and I, your exalted prince, were brought together by fate." The princess and the second prince exchanged several words of greeting before the second prince finally took notice of Jian Chen. "If I am not mistaken, then you must be fourth master of the Qing Yang clan, Qing Yang Xiangshen." The second prince revealed a faint smile on his face, but his expression was haughty and his words did nothing to hide his arrogance. He even looked at Jian Chen with a look of disdain. "That is correct, I am he." Jian Chen spoke emotionlessly. The second smiled before turning to look at the princess. "Princess, I wish to speak with Qing Yang Xiangshen in private." For a moment, the princess hesitated before finally standing up from her seat. "Then I won't be disturbing you two." Then, she walked out of the pavilion and across the sea of flowers by herself. After the princess left, the smile on the second prince's face disappeared only to be replaced with a threatening stare at Jian Chen. "Qing Yang Xiangshen, this prince knows of your engagement with the princess. But the princess is someone I have my eye on already. Each and every single suitor of the princess won't be getting past me, so this prince hopes that you will go to the king and rescind the marriage. Jian Chen gave a mocking look toward the second prince before speaking. It isn't your turn to meddle in my affairs. Furthermore, you do not even have the rights to interfere. Your Majesty, if you don't have anything to say, please excuse yourself. The second prince's face changed color as his eyes began to gain a cold and detached look. Qing Ying Xiangshen, do you understand the words you are saying? Do you truly wish to have me as your enemy? Could it be that you wish for your Qing Yang clan to be destroyed? It would appear that you know not of the strength of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. Jian Chen's mouth revealed a cold smile. With the second prince being so impolite, Jian Chen didn't bother to give any face to the prince. With disdain, he spoke, "Your Majesty, do you have the qualifications to even be called my enemy? The Qing Yang clan is not one you can anger. As for the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom, do you believe that with just a single command, I could have your entire Heavenly Eagle Kingdom disappear overnight? Outrageous!" The second prince roared in anger as his hand broke apart the stone table in two. His eyes glared fiercely with killing intent at Jian Chen before yelling, "Qing Yang Xiangshen, you know not of the difference between the heavens and the earth. Since you are so willing to walk the path of doom, allow this prince to see you through and through. Knowing that you have now insulted my Heavenly Eagle Kingdom, there will be no one to save you now. Come, apprehend him. We shall bring him back to the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom to see how my father will deal with him." The two bodyguards standing behind the second prince walked forward with dark faces. The cold glints in their gazes carried powerful killing intent. Jian Chen's words just now had caused murderous thoughts to arise in both people. They both stretched a hand toward Jian Chen's shoulders with little concern for him. The corners of Jian Chen's mouth tilted up into a sneer of disdain. His finger lit up, causing azure and violet sword chi to shoot out and head straight toward the two people's outstretched palms. Chapter 457, Ming Dong pays a visit. The two soldiers didn't anticipate that Jian Chen would actually fight back, and the azure and violet sword chi was extremely fast as well. They had no time to dodge at all, so their palms were instantly skewered through with the sword chi, staining the area with blood. The two men instantly looked shocked as the sudden pain in their palms caused them to cry out involuntarily. They couldn't believe what had happened as they looked down at their own hands in surprise. Neither of them had expected the fourth master to be so capable. Although they were shocked, they weren't yet afraid of him. Even after taking the first loss, they didn't have any desire to retreat just yet. A large amount of saint force flowed out from the both of them to form their saint weapons. Grabbing them, they stabbed out at Jian Chen. The instant the two guards formed their saint weapons, the second prince quickly retreated back in fright. He clearly understood their strengths, and he didn't think that the fourth master of the Qing Yang clan would be able to force them to bring out their saint weapons. This event to him only served to scare him. Still sitting in the stone chair, Jian Chen's eyes showed contempt as he looked at the two guards striking at him. His hand waved gently, causing sword chi to shoot out from his fingers, slamming into the two saint weapons. When the azure and violet sword chi made contact, the two guards shook from the blow as a tremendous energy vibrated through their saint weapons and made their entire right arm go numb. Their arms felt heavy as they tried to hold their saint weapon and their feet were dragged back away from the pavilion. The second prince looked at the two guards in shock. His expression revealed his astonishment. While he expected Jian Chen to react, he hadn't expected to see such a result like this. His two guards were both Earth Saint Masters, so none of the three had expected any resistance. The sounds of battle had been heard by the princess, who was appreciating the flowers from some distance away. Quickly hurrying on over, her eyes hovered over the broken stone table and asked, "What has happened for a fight to suddenly take place?" Standing up from his chair, Jian Chen walked to the side of the pavilion with his arms by his side. Looking at the second prince, Jian Chen spoke calmly, "Your Highness, you should understand that a loose tongue invites trouble. I hope that you will take notice of what you say. This world is not the world of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom." The second prince's face grew extremely dark as he listened to Jian Chen. "A loose tongue invites trouble. Those are smart words, Qing Yang Xiangshen. This prince will remember those words. The future is long. We will wait and see what happens next." After those words, the second prince and his two guards left the place in a saddened state. Looking at the second prince retreat, Jian Chen had a faint cold smile on his face. The Heavenly Eagle Kingdom was not something he could bother with. The princess had a complicated stare as she looked at Jian Chen before walking to his side. Qing Yang Xiangshen, he is the prince of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom and this is the Imperial Palace of the Jisun Kingdom. Would this not attract trouble? There's no need to worry. I know what the appropriate behavior will be. If trouble truly does come, I will bear responsibility. Jian Chen spoke flatly. That wasn't my intention. The princess tried to explain but was then interrupted by Jian Chen. Princess Yu Yu, we should return now. The second prince of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom was without a doubt one of the most heavily watched people within the Imperial Palace. Not too long after Jian Chen and the princess had left, the news that the second prince had suffered a loss in the flower garden had made its way to the ears of those people with influence. Even Qing Yangba and Bai Yunshan, who were chatting with the king, had heard the news along with the other officials and the princes of the Imperial Palace. Within a splendid and luxuriously decorated palace room, three youths in their 20s sat by each other and were eating merrily. On the table, all sorts of exotic delicacies could be seen. Suddenly, a soldier came running into the room and spoke several words into the ears of two of the youths. Straight away, the two youths had shocked expressions flash over their faces. With a wave of their hand to dismiss the guard, they grew even more serious. Princes, what has happened? The other youth asked in confusion. The guards just sent us news that the fourth master of the Qing Yang clan has offended the second prince of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. This isn't good. The Heavenly Eagle Kingdom isn't a kingdom we can stand to offend. One of the princes spoke. What? Qing Yang Xiangshan? The third youth spoke in surprise before revealing a happy smile. Could it be that the fourth master, Qing Yang Xiangshan, has returned? That's correct. Qing Yang Xiangshan has only just returned. We only just received information of that not too long ago. Seeing Brother Ming Dong's expression, could it be that you know him? The other prince spoke. Ming Dong nodded his head. I didn't think he would return that quickly, and to the Imperial Palace no less. Fellow princes, I will be taking my leave first then. With that, Ming Dong quickly left the two princes sitting by the table with looks of surprise and disbelief. Qing Yang Xiangshan knows Brother Ming Dong? A prince muttered in surprise. The second prince of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom looked furious as he and his bodyguards stormed back into his resting room. As soon as he entered the room, he slammed a palm onto a nearby table, causing the pricey wooden table to split in two. Qing Yang Xiangshan, I will make you regret this. The disgrace you've brought me today, I will definitely return this favor back to you 1,000-fold. The second prince's eyes held a ferocious glare. As a prince of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom, no matter where he went, he had never been so humiliated before. By the time the Prime Minister had come back with an unhappy face, when he saw the furious look on the second prince, he couldn't help but ask out of curiosity, "Second prince, what has happened to make you so angry?" The men of the Qing Yang clan are far too unbridled. After saying those words, the second prince recounted his tale of what had transpired in the flower garden. After hearing it, even the Prime Minister's face had grown serious as he spoke. To be able to push back two Earth Saint Masters at the age of 20, that sort of talent is terrifying. It is no wonder the Jisun Kingdom's king specifically chose the Qing Yang clan. It was because of Qing Yang Xiangshan. The second prince turned to look at the Prime Minister. Prime Minister, could it be that your discussion with the king failed as well? The Prime Minister nodded his head. That's correct. The king is adamant on having the princess marry Qing Yang Xiangshan. Even if I were to move the entire Heavenly Eagle Kingdom here, he would not budge an inch. However, the king is in his right to do as he does. If I were him, I would act in the same manner. I never imagined that Qing Yang Xiangshan had such a strength like this. If a talent like this is given time to grow, his future will hold no barriers. It is possible that he may usher the Jisun Kingdom into a golden age. The second prince's eyes flashed with a fierce killing intent before speaking. He is a threat to the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. In the case that the Jisun Kingdom grows strong, They will endanger our kingdom. Qing Yang Xiangshan cannot be left to live. With each word he spoke, his voice grew progressively colder. The Prime Minister nodded. That's correct, I have the same sentiments as well. With Qing Yang Xiangshan speaking such outrageous words, this gives us an excuse to act. Then I will bring some experts to take down Qing Yang Xiangshan. Unable to wait for even another moment, the second prince began to move. Wait a moment. The Prime Minister spoke. Your Highness, this servant has two ways to solve this. Then, he began to whisper into the second prince's ear. Jian Chen and the princess returned to the imperial palace where the king and his parents were still chatting to each other. Ah, my son-in-law, your timing is impeccable. Since you and Yue are no longer young, I believe that it would be a fine time to quickly wed the two of you. The king laughed as if he was in a hurry to quickly wed his daughter. Qing Yangba and Bai Yunshan both had smiles on their faces as well as clear indications that they stood with the king. Hearing this, Jian Chen hesitated for a moment. Your Majesty, there is still some matters I need to take care of in the near future. I do not have time to consider a relationship at this moment, so we should postpone this wedding for now. The king narrowed his eyebrows and shared a look with Qing Yangba with an awkward expression. Father, your daughter also wishes to postpone the marriage for a later date. The princess suddenly spoke with a face that betrayed no emotion at all. Hearing that Jian Chen and the princess both wished to postpone the marriage, the king had no other choice. With a sigh, he replied, "Fine then, since you two both wish to postpone it, then we shall postpone it." The king's face could barely hide his disappointment. Now that the fourth master of the Qing Yang clan had a status far unlike the one before, the king could only go along with him and feared to go against him. Xianger, why are you doing this? Bai Yunshan had a reproachful look. Mother, your son still has many things to do. There is no time at the moment for a marriage. Jian Chen had a bitter smile on his face. To the others, he was an imperial protector of the Qinghai Kingdom with the strength of a heaven saint master, but only he himself knew the extent of his strength. The wedding being postponed indefinitely had caused Qing Yangba, Bai Yunshan, and the king to all feel disappointed. As parents, they had naturally want to see their own child start a family, especially to a person that was superior in their traits. Everyone left soon afterward with Jian Chen and his parents heading to the room allocated for them. It was one of the more expensive palace rooms that was specifically made to receive such guests. At that moment, a guard came running in with a message. A report for the fourth master Qing Yang Xiangshan. There is a man named Ming Dong seeking audience. Chapter 458, Midnight Assassination. At that moment, a guard came running in with a message. A report for the fourth master Qing Yang Xiangshan. There is a man named Ming Dong seeking audience. Hearing Ming Dong's name, Jian Chen was stunned for a moment before a joyous smile overtook his face, and he quickly left the room. Seeing Jian Chen walk out of the palace, the white-robed youth standing outside revealed a smile. This was the Ming Dong that Jian Chen hadn't seen for half a year. Ming Dong had a happy smile as he walked toward Jian Chen and slapped him on the shoulders. Hey, Jian Chen, you actually did return. I was expecting you to come back later. Jian Chen looked over Ming Dong. There was a noticeable difference from the Ming Dong of half a year ago to the one right now. His aura had calmed down a bit and he no longer looked as impatient as before. Let's talk inside. Jian Chen laughed as he brought Ming Dong into the palace. This was the special palace allocated to Jian Chen by the king, so there were around 50 black armor soldiers outside. The two sat down in two chairs. A maid brought the two some snacks and two cups of tea before leaving after being dismissed. I was just planning on going to find you, but who would have thought that you were hiding away in the palace? Jian Chen was quite delighted. Ming Dong and him were like good brothers. Now that they had both met once again, they were naturally be happy. Back when the war had only just finished, I accepted the king's invitation. His kindness is a hard thing to decline, so I stayed within the palace for several days to try out the lifestyle here. This is the very first time I've lived in such a way, so I decided to stay for a little longer. Ming Dong laughed. Then are you done with such a lifestyle? Jian Chen laughed. Ming Dong took a bite of his snack and began to chew before speaking vaguely. I originally planned on staying for a little longer. But now that you're back, wherever you go, then I, Ming Dong, will naturally follow. Suddenly, Ming Dong looked to Jian Chen. Ah, Jian Chen, should I call you Qin Ying Xiangshen or Jian Chen? Just call me Jian Chen, I rather like that name. The name Qin Ying Xiangshen is something only my clan calls me. Outside of that, I am Jian Chen. Jian Chen spoke without hesitation. Ming Dong nodded his head before looking serious. The assignment you gave me has already been completed. The heavens' stolen fortune has already been given to your father. I know of your circumstances too. When the time comes, don't forget to call for me to help deal with the Huoyun sect. Jian Chen laughed. There's no need. I've already dealt with the Huoyun sect. Ming Dong was startled for a moment before he asked in confusion. Dealt with? How so? Don't tell me that you've forgiven the Huoyun sect that easily. Jian Chen and Ming Dong continued to talk through the night. When it came to Ming Dong, Jian Chen did not hide anything. Everything that had happened after the two had split, Jian Chen told him aside from the matter with the tiger cub. It wasn't because he didn't trust Ming Dong, but it was because the fewer people that knew about it, the better. Plus, if he did tell Ming Dong, there was a chance Ming Dong would feel a larger amount of pressure. After listening to Jian Chen speak of what happened, Ming Dong let out a slow breath of air. It was when Jian Chen spoke of the battle with the Eight Heaven Saint Masters that Ming Dong had nearly leaped out of his skin. I never thought that so many things like that could happen. The Jiaid clan and Shi family cannot be allowed to get away with this. Wait until we gain enough strength. We will definitely make those two pay a heavy price. But Jian Chen, this disaster has brought you some profit as well. Although you came across such misfortune, your strength has grown exponentially. You're even a Heaven Saint Master now, as well as an Imperial Protector of the Kainhuai Kingdom. I can barely believe it. If I'm not wrong either, you're only 21 years old. It was only when it was late at night that Ming Dong left Jian Chen's place. As an esteemed guest of the Jisun Kingdom, he had his own room. After Ming Dong left, Jian Chen walked into his own room and sat on the bed to meditate. At this time, the tiger cub that had previously been sleeping on the bed, from absorbing the heavenly resources, finally awoke. Refreshed, the tiger cub stood on all four of its limbs and blinked its bright eyes at Jian Chen. Then, its body leaped onto Jian Chen's shoulder and used its shaggy head to rub Jian Chen's face as it let out a purr of content. The cub was able to control the size of its own body, so at the moment, its body was about the size of a third of a meter. This was the equivalent to the size of a small cat, making it look rather cute. Taking the cub into his hands, Jian Chen regarded the strength of the cub with a small smile on his face. In just these past few days, the tiger cub had reached the strength of a class 3 magical beast. This rate of growth was absolutely terrifying, and if this trend were to continue and he had enough heavenly resources, then it wouldn't even take another year for the cub to become a class 5 magical beast. It's no wonder that the heavenly tiger god was a being only seen in the ancient past. This rate of growth is far too quick. Jian Chen sighed with admiration. Taking out several roots of thousand-year heavenly resources from his space ring, Jian Chen spoke, "Continue to work hard and improve your strength. That way, you will be able to defend yourself." There was an undeniable allure from the heavenly resources to the small cub. Upon seeing the thousand-year heavenly resources in Jian Chen's hands, the tiger cub's eyes began to sparkle before it quickly wolfed them down. Once it had ate its fill, with a content glint in its eyes, it curled up on Jian Chen's bed before falling asleep to absorb the resources. Seeing the sleeping tiger cub, a look of worry crossed Jian Chen's face. As time goes on, the amount of heavenly resources will be larger, and the amount of time needed to absorb them will increase as well. I don't know how much longer the heavenly resources I have on hand will last me. I will have to think of a solution soon. Afterward, Jian Chen slowly closed his eyes as he brought out two class 5 monster cores. Without any ruler armaments, Jian Chen could only rely on the energy within the monster cores to convert to chaotic force. Jian Chen knew that the chaotic force was extremely strong, and despite it having no use at the current moment, there would be a day in the future where he would be able to use it after establishing a foundation for it. This foundation was his body. If he could strengthen his body, he would be able to withstand the chaotic force coursing through it. So right now, he needed enough chaotic force to strengthen his body. When he could make use of the chaotic force, Jian Chen was confident that his strength would make another large leap in quality. After half the night, when the entire palace was a fearful calm, a squadron of Black Armor soldiers continued to patrol. They made their way around the Imperial Palace, moving in every direction in an attempt to protect the peace. Suddenly, a single figure hidden in the night came flashing forward, headed toward Jian Chen's palace without a single sound. The darkness of the night protected his body from detection, as if he had become one with the darkness. Even if someone were to get close to him, they would be hard-pressed to know that he was there. This mysterious figure easily dodged the outermost Black Armor soldiers protecting the palace and slipped inside. Like the outside, the inner palace was dark without any lighting. The surrounding darkness bore no effect on the figure, allowing him to see everything clearly. Looking around himself, the figure silently entered Jian Chen's room, where he saw Jian Chen sitting on his bed meditating. Inching closer to Jian Chen until he was within 10 meters, the figure took out a jade bottle and gently uncorked it, causing a faint gas to float toward Jian Chen. Waiting for the gas to fully assimilate into the room, he put away the bottle and replaced it with a black dagger. With a black stream of light, the dagger in his hand instantly shot toward Jian Chen's throat. Suddenly, an azure and violet glow of light flashed in the room before the crisp sound of metal hitting metal could be heard. The forward momentum of the dark figure came to a grinding halt before his legs staggered back several steps. With each step he made, the clear, distinct sounds of footsteps could be heard. How uncommon to think that I would come across someone with the dark attributed saint force. A gentle voice could be heard within the dark room. As if the darkness hadn't affected his vision either, Jian Chen opened his eyes from his meditative state and stared straight at the figure hiding in the darkness. You're not affected? How can that be? The hidden assailant cried out in shock. Jian Chen laughed. Your poison was far too weak and had no effect on me. The figure knew that his assassination attempt had failed and he had even been discovered. This was a battle that he could not win. Without hesitation, the figure flashed away in a streak of dark light toward the outside without a sound. Dark attributed cultivators were nicknamed the kings of the night. The nighttime was their domain. They could hide their auras perfectly within the darkness as if they were one with the night, making it hard for anyone to detect them. Did you think running would be that easy? Jian Chen laughed as he clutched at the air with his hand, causing the previously dark room to be illuminated. In an instant, a fire red sword materialized in the room. The room was lit up from the light of a red flame that startled the guards on the outside. Whoosh! With a wave of his hand, the fire sword quickly shot away, like an arrow, from the room and ultimately toward the dark figure. Bang! A fierce explosion could be heard as the light from the fire spread throughout the sky, alerting the entire palace. The assailant was engulfed by the flames with a scream, revealing his position. His clothes had been set aflame, and although he had managed to escape the fire, he had suffered serious injuries. An assassin. There's an assassin. The previously quiet palace quickly turned lively as many Black Armor soldiers came running toward the source with torches. Many figures flashed across the rooftops as the higher skilled figures charged toward the flames at a rapid pace. Upon seeing his position was revealed, the assailant had no wish to remain here any longer. He tried to climb into the darkness to escape despite his wounds. At that moment, an azure and violet flash of light could be seen flying at an extremely fast pace, blocking the man from escaping. Chapter 459, one after another. How outrageous to dare try to assassinate the brother of I, Ming Dong. You truly don't wish to live. Ming Dong's face was dark as his eyes revealed a ferocious killing intent. He lashed out with a gust of wind attributed saint force directed at the head of the assailant. Bang! Following the muffled sounds of contact, the assassin's head had blood fly out from where he was hit. Ming Dong had cracked his skull, causing a part of it to dent in a little bit. Without another sound, The assassin fainted. All of the Earth Saint Masters within the palace had finally arrived by the assassin's side. Each one held a single torch to illuminate the night and peered down to look at the assassin's face. The assassin's clothes had already disintegrated into ashes so that he was almost naked. Even his hair had been burned away and his skin was a darkened hue. His face had been disfigured, and with the injury given to him by Ming Dong, his appearance was already far too long gone to know who he was. Quickly, 100 Black Armor soldiers came rushing forward, with even more Black Armor soldiers starting to congregate from all over into the area. "What has happened just now?" a deep voice called out from behind as the king came striding forward in his sleeping clothes along with several bodyguards. "Your Majesty, an assassin infiltrated the palace in an attempt to assassinate the fourth master of the Qingyang clan, but he was apprehended in the end," a Black Armor soldier reported to the king in a low whisper. Hearing this, the king had a dark expression. "Arrest the assassin and throw him into the prisons. Interrogate him until we find out just who he is." "Yes." Immediately, several soldiers took the fainted assassin and bound him up. Afterward, two Earth Saint Masters personally took the assassin away from the area. By this point, Jian Chen had arrived as well, with both hands behind his back as he strolled toward everyone with a calm expression. Walking to Jian Chen's side, Ming Dong asked, "Jian Chen, are you alright?" Shaking his head, Jian Chen responded, "I'm fine, he didn't touch me." With concern, the king arrived by Jian Chen's side as well. "Son-in-law, are you unharmed?" "That assassin didn't harm you, I hope." "You needn't worry, this king will do his best to investigate this matter." With Jian Chen's newfound status supporting the Jisun kingdom, the king's personality to him had changed to be even more respectful. Jian Chen hesitated for a moment before nodding his head. "Then I'll be troubling you." News of a mysterious assassin infiltrating the palace had caused ripples through the palace. Not only was the king surprised, but even the Imperial Palace's Heaven Saint Master Yi Ming had been startled before coming in person. The appearance of an assassin was no small matter, and his target was a particularly special person. However, as a suggestion of Jian Chen's, the matter was quickly brought to rest. Not too long later, the palace had grown silent once more. But now, even more Black Armors could be seen patrolling the palace during the night. And right outside Jian Chen's palace, the amount of soldiers had quadrupled in number, leaving 200 Black Armors standing around. Although the king knew that this served as decorative purposes only, it was the least he could do on the surface. Jian Chen returned to his room and sat back down on the bed once more. Both of his eyes had a glint that radiated with a cold killing intent. The night quickly passed, but in the morning, the loud sounds of clamor could be heard outside. Several Black Armor soldiers stood right outside the palace gates in a single line with stone expressions. They radiated a fierce spirit ready to kill. The head soldier spoke in a polite voice, "Your Highness the Second Prince and Honored Prime Minister, this is the Imperial Palace of the Fourth Master of the Qingyang Clan. Without his permission, you cannot go inside." Opposite of them, a dozen soldiers dressed in a similar fashion from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. Leading that group at the front was the Second Prince and the Prime Minister. "Qingyang Xiangshen has insulted our Heavenly Eagle Kingdom, and even more serious, he has treaded upon the honor of our kingdom. You will stand aside now. If not, then do not blame us for being rude." The Second Prince spoke harshly with an imposing amount of power. Although this was the Imperial Palace of the Jisun Kingdom, none of the people from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom saw the kingdom as a threat in any way. "Your Highness, no matter what the reason is, you cannot go in. Unless you have received the permission of the Fourth Master, we cannot let you in." The soldier spoke without backing down. "HMPH, a tiny soldier is actually blocking the path of a prince? How preposterous is that?" The prince grew furious and waved a hand. "Charge in. If there's anyone that obstructs your way, give them no mercy." "Yes." The group from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom shouted as they waved their saint weapons. Although they had only 40 people, each one of them were Earth Saint Masters. Even at the peak of the Jisun Kingdom, the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom's strength was many times stronger than them and could easily dispatch multiple Earth Saint Masters. In contrast, out of the 200 Black Armors, only 5 of them were Earth Saint Masters. The rest were Great Saint Masters in majority. Thus, the difference between the two kingdoms' strengths was as clear to see as night and day. Despite this, however, the Black Armors refused to show any weakness and brought out their saint weapons. "Stay your hand," a sudden voice called out as Jian Chen came walking out from his palace out of the blue. On his face, a dark expression could be seen as he took notice of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. "Cheng Yang Xiangshen, I had thought that you would at least try to hide, but you actually came out." The second prince's eyes were like fire as they burned with the humiliation that was etched in his memory. One step at a time, Jian Chen walked out from the palace and toward the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom's group with cold eyes. "Explain your reason for coming today." "Cheng Yang Xiangshen, you insulted my Heavenly Eagle Kingdom yesterday and stomped upon my kingdom's honor. If you have any sense left, then sit still and let yourself be captured so we can bring you back to our kingdom to await the king's punishment. Otherwise, you'll have to bear the responsibility if you don't." The second prince spoke arrogantly. This time he had been prepared and brought multiple experts so he wasn't afraid of Jian Chen. Jian Chen's face had a cold smile on it as he looked at them with disdain. "Second prince, if you leave now, then I'll let bygones be bygones. Otherwise, I will offer you the same advice. You will have to bear the responsibility of your actions." The second prince's eyes flashed fiercely. "You seek death? Arrest him." As soon as the second prince spoke, the Earth Saint Masters had charged straight at Jian Chen. "Obstruct them," the leader of the Black Armors shouted. 5 of their Earth Saint Masters immediately flew forward to stop the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. Jian Chen gave a small snort before pointing a finger. Several rays of azure and violet sword qi flew out from his fingertips and instantly shot toward several of the Earth Saint Masters from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. The Heavenly Eagle Kingdom's Earth Saint Masters were just about to fight the Black Armors. Therefore, they hadn't paid any attention to Jian Chen. In the next moment, the sword qi pierced a hole straight through their chests. The experts of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom let out grunts as they retreated backward. They revealed looks of astonishment as they looked at Jian Chen behind the Black Armors. "Cheng Yang Xiangshen, do you truly wish to make the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom your enemy? You don't know the extent of our Heavenly Eagle Kingdom." The Prime Minister spoke seriously. Jian Chen had beaten his expectations by large margin. "And what does the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom matter?" "Two envoys from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom, do you believe that you will be able to walk away from the Jisun Kingdom's palace today?" As soon as the Prime Minister spoke, another aggressive-sounding voice could be heard from behind. At this voice, the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom experts turned around with an incredibly furious expression. A single white-robed youth around the age of 28 came walking forward. The previous words were clearly spoken by him. "Chapter 460, you and what army?" The second prince let out an angry smile. "Good. Very well then. It seems that the Jisun Kingdom truly wishes to make the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom our enemy." "Youngster, it matters not who you are. Today this prince will ensure that you do not leave this place alive." "You and what army?" The youth's face had a look of disdain on it. Such a look of disdain caused the second prince to burst into a furious storm. If it weren't for the fact that he had no idea who this youth was, he would have long since ordered his soldiers to attack. "Sire, who are you? Do you know that your words may be giving trouble to the Jisun Kingdom?" The Prime Minister spoke with a dark expression. The youth laughed. "This one is named Ming Dong. I am not from the Jisun Kingdom, so don't even bother linking me with them." "Cheng Yang Xiangshen is my sworn brother. If you truly dare to seek trouble with my brother, you will first have to go through me." "Very well, then allow us to see what sort of power you have to act so savagely." The second prince looked angrily at Ming Dong with a furious look. "Go and capture him." 3 more experts from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom charged toward Ming Dong with bright but cold eyes. Their saint weapons rippled with a large amount of energy as they surrounded and struck at Ming Dong without mercy. With a little snort, Ming Dong's eyes flashed with a cold light as his saint force condensed in his right hand. In the next moment, A cyan-colored longsword materialized in his hand before striking out three times to meet the three saint weapons of his enemies. Following the metallic clang from the clash, the three Earth Saint Masters from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdoms paled in the face. Although the youth in front of them was quite young, his strength was no less than theirs. The cyan-colored sword had contained a stronger amount of saint force than their own weapons, and he was far more of a match for them. With this single collision, the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom's experts had been forced back several steps with startled expressions as they looked at Ming Dong. A sixth cycle Earth Saint Master, you've reached such a level? One of the Earth Saint Masters cried out in shock as disbelief filled his face. They themselves were geniuses with talent, but it was only after making use of a large amount of resources and dozens years of hard work that they were able to make it to the realm they were in now. But now, there was a youth that was no older than 30 years with a strength far beyond their own. This to them was a huge shock. What? He's a sixth cycle Earth Saint Master. The second prince was startled as well. Looking at Ming Dong's young face, his heart felt disbelief. However, his face darkened for a moment before speaking. It matters not if he's a sixth cycle Earth Saint Master. Have some of you go capture him for daring to speak such arrogant words to your prince. This cannot be forgiven. Otherwise, where would the honor of our Heavenly Eagle Kingdom go? Yes. At the prince's command, another six Earth Saint Masters came forward to strike at Ming Dong. His Majesty the King has arrived. Suddenly, a single large cry could be heard as the king and several black armor soldiers could be seen walking by his side in a hurry. The king wore a long white robe with his hair somewhat disheveled. Clearly, he had been in a rush to come over. Qing Yangba and Bai Yunshan were right behind him. The king cast an eye down at the spectacle before him before looking to the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom with a dark look. Second prince, what is the meaning of this? There was an angry look to the king's eyes as his attitude toward the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom dropped several degrees in temperature. Your Majesty, Qing Yang Xiangshan and Ming Dong are far too impudent and have offended my Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. This prince wishes to take these two back home to await my father's punishment. Each and every man that dares to offend my Heavenly Eagle Kingdom cannot be forgiven. This is a matter that you should stay out of. The second prince spoke coldly as if to look down on the king. Second prince, you will take your men and leave this place at once. If you continue to make trouble, then your Heavenly Eagle Kingdom will not be able to handle the consequences. The second prince snorted, Your Majesty, could it be that you wish to get in the way of my Heavenly Eagle Kingdom? Second prince, this is the Imperial Palace of the Jisun Kingdom. This is not your Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. The king was furious now. Now that the Jisun Kingdom had the rapport of the Kainhuai Kingdom, he no longer feared the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. Furthermore, the Imperial Protector of the Kainhuai Kingdom was his future son-in-law. This connection between them was nearly as tight as iron. And if we continue to persist on this matter? The Prime Minister asked. If you continue to persist on making trouble within the Imperial Palace, then do not expect I, Yi Ming, to be sensitive to your feelings. A sound came from the sky as the white-robed figure of Yi Ming came flying in, landing right beside the king. Prime Minister Che let out a snort. It appears that the Jisun Kingdom truly desires to see our Heavenly Eagle Kingdom as an enemy. Fine then, Senior Georgian, we will be troubling you to make the first move. At the Prime Minister's words, a single 50-year-old man came forward from the group. The man was rather ordinary looking without any single outstanding detail to him. A figure like him would be easily looked over. I didn't think that your envoy group would have a Heaven Saint Master. I, Yi Ming, have made an error in judgment. Yi Ming laughed with eyes that revealed some astonished. The Prime Minister and the Second Prince were practically oozing with confidence, leading the Prime Minister to say, A prince of our Heavenly Eagle Kingdom came from far away. If there was no Heaven Saint Master as his bodyguard, the king would never be satisfied. That much is true. Yi Ming nodded in agreement. However, you only have one Heaven Saint Master, That does not change much. Georgian stepped forward with a earth-shattering amount of power flowing out from his body. It appears that your Jisung kingdom is dead set on making our heavenly eagle kingdom your enemy. Qing Yang Xiangshan and Ming Dong are two characters that we will definitely bring back. If you continue to intervene, then our two kingdoms will meet again with swords and shields. At this moment, Jian Chen spoke, Senior Yi Ming, since they are so determined to take me, then let them take me. I will settle this matter myself, you needn't join in. Jian Chen spoke with a calm expression, but his eye toward the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom was full of discontentment. Yi Ming and the king both looked at each other for a moment before the king spoke. All right, since that is what my son-in-law wishes for, then this king dares not disagree. Jian Chen, this group of men is too impudent. We have to teach him a lesson. I'll cheer you on. Ming Dong spoke. He knew just how strong Jian Chen was in his heart. Jian Chen nodded his head with a smile, facing the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. He spoke, since your group wishes to take me back, hurry up and make your move. I don't have that much time to squander with you, you rampant brat. Georgian's face grew dark. He knew that Jian Chen was quite strong himself, but he made the first move anyway, transforming into a blur of light. His right hand rippled with saint force before attempting to slam it into Jian Chen's throat. Jian Chen's right hand made a fist and brought a large amount of the fire element in the world around it. Without any hesitation, he brought it against Georgian's own hand. As the two sides met, a large amount of energy flowed in every direction, causing dirt and sand to fly everywhere, throwing up a dust storm that covered the entire place. After the strike, Georgian's body was sent flying back. With a startled look at Jian Chen, he exclaimed, "That was the energy of the world. If you can control the energy of the world, you've already stepped into the realm of the Heaven Saint Masters." At this remark, those who had not known about Jian Chen's strength let out looks of extreme disbelief. Even the normally stone-faced black armor soldiers were shocked. What, a Heaven Saint Master? Qing Yang Xiangshan is a Heaven Saint Master? No, that can't be. That can't be possible. The second prince grew pale instantly as shock registered on his face. Even the prime minister had a nasty look on his face. It is quite unfortunate that you found out too late. Jian Chen spoke coldly. A bright glow of azure and violet light could be seen as Jian Chen brought the origin energy of the sword spirits toward Georgian. Knowing that he was now fighting a man of equal ranking as him, Georgian could hold back no longer. Immediately bringing out his saint weapon, he slashed at Jian Chen as well. Ding! Georgian simply had no idea how strong the origin energy of the sword spirits were. At the moment of impact, between the saint weapon and origin energy, a large metallic sound could be heard before a decent-sized hole appeared on Georgian's saint weapon. PFT. Georgian sprayed out a mouthful of blood as his face instantly grew pale. At the same time, he looked down at his saint weapon with a look of shock. Hao. How is this possible? Yo. You damaged my saint weapon. Georgian cried out in shock. Fear flooded his body in waves and completely unsettled him. Jian Chen gave Georgian no breathing room and immediately brought the origin energy together in a resplendent light that shot toward Georgian a second time. After taking a loss the first time, Georgian was now afraid of the azure and violet sword spirits. Fearing a second clash, he immediately dodged the blow. Jian Chen hadn't stopped to rest after the miss. Making use of the origin energy, he considered it to be the same as his old light twin sword. Despite not having any saint force inside his body to support himself or maintain a high speed, with the wind element aiding him, Jian Chen's speed was not too slow either. Georgian had only just dodged the third blow by a narrow margin, but before he could stabilize himself, Jian Chen's fourth sword strike had already come down on him, forcing Georgian in a situation where he couldn't dodge. He could only use his saint weapon to block it. As the two weapons clashed, Georgian's saint weapon gained a new nick as it took damage once more. This caused his body to be injured as well. Blasted, what power is this? How could you be that strong? Georgian was astounded. Against such a powerful strike, He hadn't even been able to dodge. In the end, he was dominated without even being able to use his full strength. With these serious injuries, Georgian's strength had taken a huge dip. In the end, after being hit by another blast of Jian Chen's fist, encased in the fire element, to his chest, Georgian flew back with a mouthful of blood flying out. Chapter 461, A Name That Spreads Everywhere. Under the eyes of everyone, Georgian was defeated by Jian Chen. He flew through the air, tumbling 20 meters away to the ground. Even after he had stopped rolling, blood could be seen pouring from his pale mouth. At this stunning sight, everyone from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom was astonished. The previously confident Second Prince and Prime Minister Che turned pale, and the Second Prince started to shiver and shake with fear. When they planned on causing trouble within the Imperial Palace of the Jisun Kingdom, they were relying heavily upon Georgian as a Heaven Saint Master. Georgian had been dealt serious injuries in several moves, indicating the difference between their strengths. Now that Georgian was powerless to defend himself, how would he be able to defend the Second Prince? The entire group of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom now had nasty looks on their faces. Each one stood by the Second Prince and Prime Minister with dignified stances as if prepared to defend them from the Jisun Kingdom. Jian Chen had been able to defeat a Heaven Saint Master in such a short amount of time. This had shocked everyone to the point of causing them to be speechless. He was so young, but he was already a Heaven Saint Master with a strength that was absolutely mind-blowing. Furthermore, the strength he wielded was not just an ordinary amount of strength. A battle between Heaven Saint Masters was usually filled with an enormous amount of energy. Victory would not be so easily determined in such a short amount of time, but Jian Chen had managed to inflict two severe wounds on a Heaven Saint Master within a brief two breaths worth of time. A strength this strong was far too shocking for anyone. Georgian coughed up violently enough for two people before slowly bringing himself up from the ground. Terrified, he looked at the young Jian Chen in front of him. He could hardly believe that Jian Chen was just a barely 20 years old youth. With such a strength like this, along with a mysterious power that could destroy Saint weapons, Georgian's heart was filled with terror. Jian Chen would hold the advantage, even in a battle against a Heaven Saint Master, because he wielded this power. At the very least, he would be able to easily kill a Heaven Saint Master. After all, in a battle between two people, a clash of weapons was unavoidable. Since Saint weapons were linked to their owner's life, if their Saint weapon was damaged, the owner would be severely damaged as well. Since Georgian was using his sword to support himself off the ground, the two jagged chips on his sword were clear to see. "Just what is this power of yours? To be able to so easily damage my Saint weapon?" Georgian looked at Jian Chen seriously. Although he tried to force himself to look calm, his words had already betrayed a hint of a stammer. That power of Jian Chen's completely terrified Georgian. Jian Chen recollected the origin energy back into his own body and wrapped his hands against his chest. "I see no need to tell you that. Men of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom, were you not quarreling earlier about capturing me? Have everyone come forth. Qingying Xiangshan will receive you." The experts from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom all looked at each other. They were caught in a situation where they could neither advance nor retreat. Now that they knew Jian Chen's strength, they had already lost the previous arrogance they had. Even the Second Prince and Prime Minister had fallen silent. Their enemy had easily defeated a Heaven Saint Master, so even if all the Earth Saint Masters were to charge at him, they would only be charging toward their deaths. A Heaven Saint Master and an Earth Saint Master were on completely separate worlds in strength. One traveled the heavens, the other traveled the earth. The difference between the two sides could not be argued about. Georgian took in a deep breath. His expression began to grow dejected as he reclaimed his Saint weapon. "I had no idea that the Jisun Kingdom would have such a blessed genius. Qingying Xiangshan, you are strong and there is no doubt that I am not a match for you. As a representative of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom, I wish to apologize for the rude display from before." Without waiting for a response from Jian Chen, Georgian began to lead the entire group away. "Halt, where are you going?" Ming Dong's figure suddenly appeared in the way of the group and laughed. "Heavenly Eagle Kingdom, Did you really think that my brother and I would be that easy to bully without consequence? You were just going on about capturing the two of us to bring back to your shitty highness as if we were beneath your notice. But now that you know you are no match, you decide to slip away? How easy do you think that'll be? Georgian's face darkened as a hint of anger flashed across his face. Then what are you thinking of? He growled. Your entire group will remain here. Do not even think about leaving the Jisung Kingdom's Imperial Palace. Ming Dong spoke coldly with an earnest look. At this, everyone from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom blanched for a moment before the Prime Minister spoke. Then do you plan to completely imprison everyone here, or do you wish to kill us all? Even the tiny Heavenly Eagle Kingdom can be so savage. Ming Dong snorted before looking to Jian Chen. Brother, how do you propose we deal with them? Last night's events cannot be so easily forgiven. Although the assassin from yesterday night had been captured, his mouth was sealed tight, and so the Jisung Kingdom were unable to figure out his true identity or affiliations. To anyone with a sharp mind, there was a mutual understanding of the truth. Jian Chen thought for a moment before waving his hand. Ming Dong, let them go. Jian Chen, don't tell me you'll let them walk away that easily. Ming Dong had an unwilling look on his face. Let them go, that is what I plan to do. Jian Chen spoke. With Jian Chen so resolute on his decision, even Ming Dong had no alternative. Stamping past the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom, he spoke, you better hope that your paths will not cross with me in the future. Otherwise, you will not get off easily. With that, Ming Dong allowed them to pass and stood by Jian Chen's side. The entire group from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom let out a sigh in relief. Without any hesitation, they quickly left the area. They no longer had any face to stay within the Jisung Kingdom. When the envoy left the palace, they immediately left for the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. Jian Chen, why did you let them go? Ming Dong asked the question that was weighing on his mind. The Jisung Kingdom has only just experienced a war and is greatly injured. We cannot bear to make the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom our enemy. Jian Chen said, what are you afraid of? Don't forget your current status. Are you afraid of a tiny kingdom like the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom? Jian Chen shook his head. Although the power of the Kainhuai Kingdom is tremendous, so is the distance from there to here. Having the army dispatched here is far too unrealistic, and since the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom is so close to the Jisung Kingdom, with their power, it is best to not be caught in a deadlock with them. Although I am not afraid, the Jisung Kingdom cannot be thrown into this. So you are thinking about the well-being of the Jisung Kingdom. Ming Dong felt relieved. He had always been alone and thus had always looked out only for himself, no matter what. Very rarely did he ever consider the consequences of his own actions, so he had not initially understood why Jian Chen had gone through such troubles. The king had reached Jian Chen's side and begun to speak several words of concern to him. His attitude was that of a father who cared for his son. Speaking kindly, the king already saw Jian Chen as his son-in-law. The disturbance of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom had quickly died back down, but Jian Chen's strength had been revealed. News of his strength spread through the Imperial Palace and had made him a revolutionary figure from within. At the same time, Jian Chen and the princess marriage had been circulated as well for everyone to know. Although the engagement had been confirmed several years ago, it had not been announced until now. Only the two sides and the Huoyun sect knew of the engagement before, making the marriage a secret within the palace. After the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom's envoys had left, the king invited Jian Chen and his family back into the palace to have a discussion in private. Not too long after, an imperial decree was given that shocked the entirety of the Jisung Kingdom. Qingyang Xiangshen, the fourth master of the Qingyang clan, would now hold the title of an imperial protector of the Jisung Kingdom with an authority that was not below the king himself. At the same time, the king announced Qingyang Xiangshen's marriage to the princess, letting everyone in the entire kingdom know about the affair. After this series of events had happened, the previously low-profiled Qingyang clan in Lore City became one of the most heavily watched clans within the entire Jisung Kingdom. Their reputation had grown to the point where everyone knew about them and could no longer be as low-profile as they were before. Furthermore, Qing Yang Xiangshen became a person of interest to everyone in the kingdom. Every single deed or achievement he had accomplished before was investigated by the masses, and they gradually learned even more things about him. The strength Jian Qin revealed at the imperial palace hadn't been kept secret. Instead, the king had secretly spread news of it. Quickly, the news of a 21-year-old Heaven Saint Master spread throughout the kingdom for everyone to know. However, this piece of information had led to everyone turning their nose up in disbelief of the news. A 21-year-old Heaven Saint Master? That was far too ridiculous. In a luxurious tavern in Lore City, a brightly red-dressed Zhuge Feng sat by himself and drank a cup of wine. Everyone had been talking about the matter with Jian Chen, but Zhuge Feng had cared not for this and turned his nose up, unconvinced. Suddenly, a random conversation at a nearby table caught Zhuge Feng's attention. "This Qing Yang clan is one of the four great clans in our Lore City, aren't they? The matters regarding their fourth master, Qing Yang Xiangshen, are things I know about. I've heard that even when he was young, he was a genius among geniuses. In Kargath Academy, he defeated a middle great saint and several other saints working together as a primary saint. How amazing is that? However, he had offended the Huayun sect and mysteriously disappeared after that without a single trace. It was only in these past 2 days that he suddenly reappeared." Zhuge Feng slowly put down the wine cup in his hand as his eyebrows knit together in thought. He was also from Lore City. Could it be him? Could it be that when he went to the Holy Lands, he managed to make the breakthrough to become a Heaven Saint Master? Chapter 462, Illusioner A. 1. After listening to Jian Chen's suggestion, the tidbit that indicated that Jian Chen was the imperial protector of the Qin Huai Kingdom was not revealed. So when he became an imperial protector for the Jisun Kingdom, several dukes and chancellors contested it, but their voices were tiny. With the king having the support of both Yiming and Kaifer, the opposition was quickly suppressed, which gave way to Jian Chen becoming an imperial protector for the Jisun Kingdom. In fact, he was now the only imperial protector the Jisun Kingdom had. The coronation ceremony for Jian Chen becoming an imperial protector was packed with people. Practically anyone that was anybody in the Jisun Kingdom showed up. Not only did the three other major clans from Lore City send their representatives to show their support, but even many people from faraway cities came to participate. This event caused the name of the Qing Yang clan to skyrocket. They completely overshadowed even the Huayun sect's power to the point where they had replaced them as the authority figure. At this, Qing Yang Ba didn't know whether to laugh or cry. There was a helpless look on his face, knowing that the Qing Yang clan could no longer be as low profile as before. Once the coronation ceremony had finished, Jian Chen and his family left the imperial palace shortly after. On the second day, they left the palace and were accompanied by 500 black armors back to Lore City. Ming Dong followed Jian Chen away from the imperial palace. Within the troops, there was a single white-dressed beauty that was very easy to see. Situated among the black armors, she was like a beautiful flower that was blossoming in a magnificent manner that was both eye-catching and dazzling. The princess of the Jisun Kingdom had begged to leave the imperial palace in order to temporarily live with the Qing Yang clan under the guise of wishing to nurture and cultivate their relationship. Qing Yang Ba and Bai Yunshan had both heartily agreed to her request, since this was what the both of them had been hoping for. With their agreement, even Jian Chen was helpless to disagree. The entire family traveled on merrily with laughter as they comforted each other with happy words. Because of the pace, they arrived back at Lore City by the afternoon of the second day. Lore City had long since received information that they were approaching, and had a giant party ready to receive them at the gates with respectful smiles and polite attitudes. After the welcoming, Jian Chen and his group returned to the Qing Yang Manor with the 500 black armors, declining to stay any longer. Once they were done with their meal, They immediately started their trek back to the Imperial Palace. The Qingyang clan was decorated with bright lights and colored banners to symbolize the happy state of the manor. Jian Chen had just stepped across the gates to the clan when he realized that there was a difference from the Qingyang clan from before. The patrolling soldiers around the clan and even the clan servants displayed prideful expressions on their faces. Their heads were also held high in a dignified fashion. Haha, clan leader. Fourth Lady, Xiangshan, you've finally arrived back home. Among the higher-ranking elders waiting for them, a familiar-looking face immediately called out to the returnees when they came into sight. I never would have imagined that my Qingyang clan would have such a talented offspring. This is truly a boon for my Qingyang clan. An elderly voice could be heard from behind only to reveal the elder that guarded the library. His face revealed a gentle smile that did nothing to hide his prideful and gratified expression. Xianger, this is your grandfather, come pay your respects. Qingyang Ba quickly spoke to Jian Chen in a low, serious voice. Hearing this, Jian Chen immediately went to salute him. I pay my respects to grandfather. The grandfather laughed before looking over Jian Chen for a moment. Nodding in approval, he spoke, neither arrogant nor hot-tempered. Good, good. Truly a dragon among men, and despite your age, you have already a dignified heir to you. Jian Chen's family members exchanged several words of greeting with the higher echelons of the clan before heading off to rest. On the way back to his own room, every single guard that saw Jian Chen immediately gave him a respectful salute. Each one looked at him with an eye of adoration while several others showed a tint of jealousy. Suddenly, outside the gates of the Qingyang clan, a richly dressed 28-year-old youth in red, with hair of the same color could be seen. His complexion was firm and his aura unordinary, making anyone that saw him know he was no ordinary person. The youth had been immediately blockaded by the guards at the gate. One of the gatekeepers immediately called out, "Halt, this is the Qingyang clan. Without an invitation, no one can enter." The youth paused right in front of the gate and spoke calmly, "I am looking for Qingyang Xiangshan." "Impudence, are you one that can call the fourth master by his name?" The two gatekeepers immediately grew solemn as they looked at the newcomer with unfriendly looks. Because of the fact that Jian Chen had elevated the Qingyang clan into a position of power among the Jisun Kingdom, the guards felt as if everyone were beneath them now. The youth was not angry and continued to speak calmly, "I am called Zhugu Feng. Go and report to Qingyang Xiangshan. If he knows me, he will naturally come out." Hearing this, the two gatekeepers gave each other a mutual look as if to send a message before calming down momentarily. One of the guards spoke, "Please wait here, I will report to the fourth master." Quickly, Jian Chen and Ming Dong, who were chatting to each other, heard about Zhugu Feng being here. With a happy look, Ming Dong and Jian Chen immediately walked for the giant gate. Seeing Jian Chen's rushed manner, the guard that came forward to alert him was startled. He thought back to the way he had treated Zhugu Feng and immediately grew afraid that Jian Chen would take his anger out on him, causing him to grow extremely anxious. He knew now that the Qingyang clan was a major power, but the one who held the power wasn't the clan leader. Instead, it was the fourth master Qingyang Xiangshan. His words were worth far more. Jian Chen arrived at the front of the gates where he saw Zhugu Feng, someone he had split paths with half a year ago. Right now, Zhugu Feng was still the same as he was before. There was no change to his appearance, and there was still a cold and detached look to him. "I don't see the wrong person, it really is you." Jian Chen laughed. Seeing that the fourth master of the Qingyang clan was the one he had been looking for, Zhugu Feng couldn't help but break out into a smile. "So you were originally called Qingyang Xiangshan. It's no wonder I wasn't able to find you for so long in Lore City." Laughing, Jian Chen didn't bother to explain at that moment and replied, "Come in, we'll talk inside." Afterward, the two guardsmen let out a breath in relief and joy the moment they had disappeared. Jian Chen had taken Zhugu Feng into the clan compound. "I didn't think that he would actually be the friend of the fourth master. It is a good thing we didn't offend him. Otherwise, it would be foolish of us to think we could remain in the Qingyang clan." One of the guards spoke with some lingering fear while the other guard nodded in agreement. Jian Chen took Zhu Gufeng into his own room and began to talk with him. From Zhu Gufeng's own mouth, Jian Chen had already known that Zhu Gufeng had left the Zhu Gu clan. From that moment on, he was no longer affiliated with the Zhu Gu clan, and whatever he did now would not affect the Zhu Gu clan in any way. The manner in which Zhu Gufeng had conducted himself gave rise to Jian Chen having respect for him. In his heart, he had already thought of Zhu Gufeng as someone worthy of respect. Although neither person had known the other for long, Jian Chen knew that he could trust him. "Ah, Jian Chen, don't you have the mercenary group? Have Zhu Gufeng enter it, our strength will increase once more with him," Ming Dong suddenly suggested. "I had that idea as well." Jian Chen smiled before his eyebrows knit together. "I don't know when Senior An and Yun Zheng will arrive." "It's simple, Jian Chen. Didn't you give an address to Senior An and Yun Zheng? All you have to do is notify the city lord and have them mask everyone that enters. This way, when Yun Zheng and Senior An arrive, we'll be notified, and if they haven't come, we won't waste any time," Ming Dong proposed. Jian Chen's eyes lit up. That is a good proposal. Zha Yu, call housekeeper Sid over." Afterward, Jian Chen told housekeeper Sid to go to the city lord and instruct him to do as commanded. Sid immediately ran for the city lord's mansion with great speed and relayed the instructions word for the city lord to hear. When the lord of Lore City heard of the command that came from the fourth master Qing Ying Xiangshen himself, he immediately grew serious. Without any hesitation, he went off to make the arrangements himself. After several days, Jian Chen had finally finished all the matters from the Jisung Kingdom as well as his own home. For now, he could relax. Late at night, Jian Chen sat on his bed and took out a map from his space ring. "It's about time to investigate that Saint Ruler's cave. I hope it does not disappoint and has a ruler's armament, Saint Ruler's skeleton, or anything else that could help me cultivate my chaotic force. When I am able to use my chaotic force, my strength will surely reach a new realm. Ah, I cannot wait." On the morning of the second day, Jian Chen told Ming Dong, Zhu Gufeng, and his parents that he would be leaving. He then flew through the air toward the cave of the Saint Ruler, indicated on the map. The cave of the Saint Ruler was situated 50,000 kilometers southwest of the Qiangan Kingdom in a mountain range. It was only 11,000 kilometers away from his Qingyang clan. It would take 2 or 3 days to arrive if Jian Chen were to travel without rest. Chapter 463, Illusion Array 2. Jian Chen quickly passed over the boundaries between the kingdoms and finally arrived at the beautiful mountain ranges on his third day of traveling. This large mountain range was extremely vast and the peaks pierced the clouds, hiding more than half the mountain from below. This mountain range was not as ordinary as it looked. There was an abundant amount of energy from the world, about 2 to 3 times the normal amount. Even without a monster core, this was still a very decent place to cultivate. In this place, double the work could be done with half the effort. Jian Chen floated 100 meters up the mountain before looking around. Sometimes, he would refer to the map in his hands as he searched for the area where the cave was. Several moments later, Jian Chen let out a sigh in disappointment. Although the map indicated that the cave of the Saint Ruler was in this mountain range, it was not all that detailed and did not accurately pinpoint where the cave was. Jian Chen looked once more at the topography of the entire area and focused on it in his mind. Putting away the map, he began to use the wind element to envelop his body, allowing him to fly into the air. At the same time, he began to spread his presence out. It covered a diameter of 15 kilometers in an attempt to scour the entire range for any hints or clues to the secret cave. Quickly, Jian Chen arrived in the depths of the mountain range when all of a sudden his eyes noticed something strange. Up ahead, there were hundreds of wooden houses scattered about in a single ring and a 50-meter-tall tower stood in the middle. On top of the tower, 3 bold words were written on it: Pure Heart Pavilion. Within the mountain ranges, there is still a hidden sect? Jian Chen was extremely curious and began to fly toward the buildings. Just as Jian Chen drew close to the Pure Heart Pavilion, an elderly voice could be heard through the air: A guest is approaching from far away. How delightful. Disciples, let us welcome him. As soon as he spoke, The doors to the houses began to open as men wearing all sorts of clothes began to walk out, both men and women, of varying age with smiles adorning their faces and a spirited aura surrounding them, appeared. At the same time, a white-robed elder came flying from the tower. The elder had a long braided hairstyle and held the air of a sage to him as if he was one who had achieved the status of an immortal. Jian Chen floated 500 meters away from the entire crowd with a suspicious look on his face as if he was trying to figure out what they would do next. His presence had already spread throughout the Pure Heart Pavilion sect grounds, and from his presence, he could clearly sense their strengths without fail. There weren't many people to the sect, about 60 people total. Aside from the long-haired elder, there was still another Heaven Saint Master gathered within the crowd. Half of the 60 people were at the Earth Saint Master realm while the remaining half were at the Great Saint Master level and under. Traveler, if you are inclined, please come sit at our Pure Heart Pavilion for a while. The floating Heaven Saint Master had a smile on his face as he spoke. Laughing, Jian Chen spoke. We are complete strangers. Sire has neither idea if I am a well-doer or an evil-doer. Yet, I am invited in on our very first meeting. Does Sire truly trust this one that much? The elder laughed in return before using his hand to stroke his beard. Pure Heart Pavilion. Ah, Pure Heart Pavilion. As the name implies, we are of pure heart with few desires. As such, our Pure Heart Pavilion is penniless and we do not covet wealth like those other sects. We desire no items, and since we disciples cultivate in hiding, we have no enemies. Friend, you think too much. Hearing this, Jian Chen had a suspicious expression on his face. He had already traveled the Tianyuan continent for a very long time and met all sorts of people, but those with pure hearts and few desires, he could safely say that he had never met anyone like that before. In that case, this one will be troubling you for a while. Jian Chen accepted with cupped hands before following them into the sect. Under Jian Chen's omnipresence, the area of the Pure Heart Pavilion wasn't hidden at all. However, what led to Jian Chen being surprised was that the elder was true to his word and the entire sect was extremely impoverished. As an example, none of the disciples could be seen wearing a space belt or ring or even anything similar. There were no monster cores, no exotic foods, or any valuable jadeite pearls or stones. Even the more fundamental items to living like rice could not be seen. Furthermore, when it came to the disciples of the sect, Jian Chen could see that they were all pure in the sense of not wishing for anything. Each one of them had an air of a person who had rejected the secular world. Knowing this, Jian Chen could hardly believe his eyes. This feeling was almost like he was in a completely different world. Jian Chen followed the elder into the tower where he was given a single cup of pure mountain water. I am Tian Xuzi, a master of sorts to the Pure Heart Pavilion. For my very young friend to reach such a high level of strength, I cannot help but find it hard to believe. Tian Xuzi sighed in admiration. Was elder able to tell my age that easily? Jian Chen was greatly astonished. Within the continent, the appearance of a person was not always an accurate method of determining age. Unless it was someone who knew of his details, anyone that saw him as a Heaven Saint Master would never believe he was as young as he looked. Another reason for that was because within the Tianyuan continent, there were many methods for a person to maintain their youthful appearance. Tian Xuzi nodded his head as his right hand moved to stroke his long beard. Slowly, he said, the mysteries within the ancient records my Pure Heart Pavilion cultivates with allows us to see the origin of everything clearly. So my young friend, I can see your age quite clearly as well. You are no older than 25 years old. At his statement, Jian Chen truly felt astonished. Seeing how Tian Xuzi's stare had a slight change to them, Jian Chen sighed in admiration. It seems that your sect truly practices an extremely mysterious record. The elder laughed. Of course, the Pure Heart secrets are truly abstruse and can decipher the origins of everything, but those capable of cultivating these secrets are rare and few. The Pure Heart Pavilion has existed on this mountain range for well over 1,000 years, but in this current generation, The sect has never had as many disciples as now. That said, we only have 80 disciples. The other 20 disciples are out traveling the continent to seek others that are capable of practicing our pure heart secrets. Those who can practice the pure heart secrets are far too few in this world. Because of the secrets, a practitioner must be pure of heart and have little desires. Otherwise, they wouldn't make any progress. At the same time, the rates in which practitioners learn at are slower than the outside world. Firstly, that is because we focus on tempering the mind. Secondly, we cannot absorb the energy within a monster core and instead absorb the pure energy of the world to slowly accumulate energy. For that reason, our speed is not yet like those of the outside world. It would appear the heavens are fair, if the pure heart secrets are that divine in power, then its restrictions make sense. Jian Chen had said, this was the very first time he had seen or heard of such a strange method of cultivation. Little friend, I know that you would not have come out here without reason. Why have you came to this mountain range? Tiang Zuzi asked. Jian Chen sat upright with both eyes staring back at Tiang Zuzi. Feigning a casual air, he asked, sire, you must have lived within these mountains for a very long time and thus know it like you know your own hand. Would sire know of any strange areas within these mountains? Tiang Zuzi gave a beaming smile at Jian Chen. The strange area you are talking about, it must be that saint rulers gave. Yes. Jian Chen's eyes lit up as he cupped his hands and smiled. Sire has an amazing prophetic ability to be able to speak so accurately. Not at all. This elder has no such ability. It is only that the cave of the saint ruler is the only area in this mountain range with any mystery to it. Tiang Zuzi spoke. The predecessor living in that cave was extremely mysterious. Using the profound mysteries of the world, he was able to control the world so that an illusion would safeguard the location of his cave and allow the saint ruler to escape detection. In fact, the illusion array he put up was far too strong for even him to break. 100 years ago, this old man went to the cave to pay my respects to the predecessor, but his body had long since withered away to becoming a skeleton. Sire has entered the cave of the saint ruler? Jian Chen was startled before growing serious. He wanted that saint ruler's skeleton. This old man cultivates a method that can see the origin of everything. While the illusion array that predecessor put up is strong, it has no effect on me. With just a small amount of effort, I would be able to enter. But the items inside, I have never touched. The pure heart secrets doesn't allow me to be tempted by such things. So the wonders and treasures that lay in there may as well be sands and stone to me. Jian Chen let out a sigh in relief. Would it be possible for sire to tell me where that cave would be? About 50 kilometers south from here, the cave lies at the bottom of a great valley. Tiang Zuzi did not hide any details from Jian Chen and told him the exact coordinates. Many thanks for the information, sire. Jian Chen spoke gratefully. That won't be necessary. Even if this old man didn't tell you, you would be able to find the cave after a small amount of effort. However, the cave is protected by an extremely strong illusion array. Only saint rulers would be able to enter it. Tiang Zuzi informed him. This one will remember that. Sire, this one still has some matters to take care of. I will be taking my leave first. Now that Jian Chen knew the location of the saint ruler's cave, he had lost his patience to stay here and quickly bid farewell to Tiang Zuzi. Tiang Zuzi watched Jian Chen fly away from his window, and when Jian Chen fully disappeared, he whispered to himself, what a truly outstanding genius. If he was able to become a heaven saint master at such a young age, then he is truly one of the strongest individuals on the continent. At the very least, he'll be the second coming of Mo Danyan. Perhaps I should report this to the master of the sect. If he is able to bring him close, then the pressure from the guardian clans will lessen by a large amount. The pressure from the beast god continent wouldn't be as stifling either. Chapter 464, Illusioner A. 3. Traveling in accordance to the directions given to him by Tiang Zuzi of the Pure Heart Pavilion, Jian Chen finally arrived at a great valley with a deep bottom. Jian Chen slowly descended toward the bottom of the valley. Tiang Zuzi had said that the cave would be at the bottom of the valley with its exact position hidden in a way that would be hard to detect. Quickly, Jian Chen arrived at the bottom of the valley. There was a giant pool that exuded a chilling frost that permeated his entire body and bones like daggers. Jian Chen looked around the dark place he was in. The visibility here was quite poor, but it was not significant enough to hamper Jian Chen, who could still see around himself. But the valley was so expansive that even his eyes could not see the entirety of the area it covered. Even more so, a chilling frost covered the area, making finding a foothold extremely difficult. This is already the deepest part of the valley. Where might the Saint Ruler's cave be? Jian Chen muttered to himself. When it came to the cave, he only knew the name. Everything else was unknown to him. Even what the cave looked like was a mystery to him. Combined with the fact that it was hidden, finding the cave would be an extremely difficult challenge. Jian Chen began to spread his omnipresence about himself to cover a 15-kilometer area. Even the places beneath the water were not hidden from him as he searched the valley for any hidden places or things. Jian Chen followed the walls of the valley as he floated in the air. Wherever he traveled, his omnipresence covered the entire area in an attempt to continue searching. Within this area of Jian Chen's presence, even the smallest ripple of energy would not go unnoticed. Right underneath the pool of water, a single water snake came leaping out of the water. Opening its jaws, the water snake came flying at Jian Chen in an attempt to bite him at a lightning-fast speed. Jian Chen's eyebrows knit together. He had noticed the water snake before, but for the sake of searching for the Saint Ruler's cave, he had ignored it. Thus, he was now annoyed by the snake's interruption. A frosty glow appeared in Jian Chen's eyes as he clutched at the sky. Suddenly, a large amount of the fire element began to gather around his hand before condensing to instantly form a giant sword made of flames. With a brilliant flash of red light, it flew toward the snake. The fire sword shot straight into the open jaws of the snake, causing it to explode from the reaction that followed. Parts of its body blew off and dispelled the nearby frost vapor from the heat of the explosion. In an instant, the previously cold area grew nice and warm. With a single thought, Jian Chen forced a single fist-sized crystal stone to fly through the mist and right into his hand. This was a Class 5 monster core. Although it was not as important to him as before, it was still worth a considerable amount. Jian Chen continued to trek through the valley while growing closer and closer to the pool of water until he was just a mere 20 meters above it. The distance was so small that the mist that was rising up from it began to dampen Jian Chen's previously dry clothing. Although the valley was extremely vast, Jian Chen had only taken 2 hours to search the entire valley. What disappointed him was the fact that he had not yet discovered the cave of the Saint Ruler. Jian Chen hovered in midair with a contemplative look. Suddenly, he looked to the water beneath him. Could it be underwater? At that thought, he immediately plunged into the water. Just as Jian Chen's body approached the water, the surface of the water suddenly split apart in two. Without a sound, it formed a giant crack. Jian Chen continued to descend into the body of water without any of the water spilling a drop onto his body. Instead, the water formed a ring around Jian Chen. The water was about 500 meters at its deepest, so Jian Chen quickly reached the bottom of the water. The temperature of this area was even colder than the surface, forcing Jian Chen to give a sigh of annoyance. An Earth Saint Master would have absolutely no chance of surviving down here. The frosty air was that big of a danger. It was so dark that any regular person wouldn't even be able to see their own fingers. But thanks to Jian Chen's omnipresence, it bore no effect on him. As he moved, Jian Chen continued to scour every single inch of the area. Although Jian Chen had already used his omnipresence to search the area above and below the water, the areas at the bottommost parts of the water were incredibly strange. Not only was it cold beyond belief, but it could even dampen Jian Chen's omnipresence. Because of that, Jian Chen didn't dare think that his search above the water was accurate. There were all sorts of monsters living within the abyss of the waters. However, even the strongest of these creatures was only Class 5 at the most. Therefore, they posed no threat to Jian Chen. Another 2 hours passed when Jian Chen had finished searching the entire area. However, Like last time, there were no new discoveries or any clues to be seen. Flying out from the water, Jianchen hovered over the surface of the chilly water with his eyebrows narrowed in concentration. He had originally thought that with his omnipresence, nothing would be able to escape his grasp and he would be able to pinpoint the Saint Ruler's cave without fail. But now that he had searched the entire place, Jianchen had finally realized that the level of concealment the cave had was far stronger than he initially thought. Tiang Zuzi said that the cave would be at the bottom of the valley. But why is it that after I've searched the entire place, I cannot find it? Jianchen muttered in heavy concentration. Perhaps Tiang Zuzi lied to me and the cave isn't located here. Perhaps this isn't the right valley he spoke of, meaning I am in the wrong place? All of a sudden, Jianchen shot high into the air like an arrow, and floated overhead the valley. When he circled around the general area, he could not find a second valley. After some time, Jianchen returned to his original position after looking 10 kilometers in the general area. There was only one valley. Returning to the bottom of the valley, Jianchen looked at the chilly water deep in thought. The Saint Ruler's cave was truly too hidden for him to find. Now, Jianchen was beginning to doubt whether or not if the cave was truly here. Master, Zhang knows where the cave you wish to find is. Suddenly, a single voice popped in Jianchen's mind. The sword spirit Zhang had noticed the vexation Jianchen was in and offered to help. Hearing this, Jianchen revealed an overjoyed look on his face and immediately thought, Zhang, would you be able to tell me where the Saint Ruler's cave is? Yes, Master. The cave is protected by an array that separates it from the world. Master's omnipresence is far too weak to be able to detect the location. Zhang spoke. Zhang, please tell me just where the cave is located. Jianchen could barely restrain the emotions flowing through to his face as he moved about impatiently. Chapter 465, Illusioner A. 4. Zhang, please tell me just where the cave is located. Jianchen could barely restrain the emotions flowing through to his face as he moved about impatiently. Master. It is located 50 meters on the wall behind you. Zhang spoke. Hearing that, Jianchen whirled around and walked to the location Zhang spoke of. There was a precipice where several weeds could be seen. From the outside, it looked rather normal and there was no cave that was visible. At the very least, Jianchen couldn't sense anything strange from it. Master, there is an illusion array concealing the cave. If you attack the area and destroy the array, you'll be able to see the cave, Zhang told him. Jianchen looked at the seemingly ordinary-looking wall with a curious expression. He couldn't believe that an illusion array would have such an amazing effect. Even with his eyes, he wasn't able to detect any abnormalities even with his omnipresence combing over it. Jianchen swiped at the sky, causing the fire element in the world to gather and form a boiling hot fire sword. Shooting forward with his hand, Jianchen struck the fire sword on the cliff wall. Bang! Following an extremely loud bang, the fire sword exploded against the cliff wall and filled the area with a burning hot heat wave. The temperature in the air soared as the flames evaporated the mist. Parts of the cliff had even broke off and splashed into the water below. After some time, the area cleared up and a single 3-meter hole became visible right in front of Jianchen. However, nothing could be seen within it. Could it be that this is the Saint Ruler's cave? Jianchen muttered. Using his omnipresence, he began to spread it inside the cave in an attempt to look inside. When his presence reached 5 meters in the cave, an unknown energy blocked it, preventing him from going any further. Master, there's still an illusion array guarding it. Zhang spoke to Jianchen. The preventions put in place are quite strict. Jianchen sighed. Back during the gathering of mercenaries, he had come across the cave of a Saint Ruler. However, that cave didn't have any protections as difficult as this one. It only had an unusually sturdy stone door blocking its path. The Saint Ruler's cave had provided an undeniable sense of enticement to Jianchen. So without hesitation, he flew inside the jet-black cave and began to walk deeper in. Quickly, Jianchen arrived at the illusion array that had blocked his omnipresence. Clutching his hand, The fire sword materialized in his hand once more. What left Jian Chen tongue-tied was the fact that when the sword drew close to the illusion array, it suddenly vanished without a trace. Master, this illusion array is borrowing the power of a space gate. Aside from attacks that are strong enough to bring the illusion array to its breaking point, it will not be destroyed. A feminine voice could be heard within his head. This time, it was King Xuo that spoke. "Then what should I do?" Jian Chen asked the sword spirit. This was the very first time he had come across an illusion array. He had never heard of such a thing before, so the existence of one was a complete mystery to him. He had no idea how to deal with it, causing him feel helpless. This illusion array borrows power from what a space gate is formed from. With the assistance of the world's power, the area within fluctuates and changes at will. It is also able to produce an endless amount of illusions to puzzle the eyes. But it cannot attack. So, unless one comes across a saint ruler, this illusion array will cause anyone that enters it to be completely isolated from the world. King Xuo spoke. Jian Chen hesitated for a moment before asking, "King Xuo, then do you have a method for dealing with this illusion array?" "Master, although Zhang and King Xuo have used up most of our energy to break the illusion array, we can still see through it. As long as Master follows what we say, we will be able to pass through the illusion array." King Xuo almost looked proud as she replied, "That's fine. I will listen to your instructions." Since things had gotten to such a stage, Jian Chen placed all his hopes on the two sword spirits. "Master, first walk into the illusion array." King Xuo started Jian Chen off. Jian Chen felt completely at ease with Zhang and King Xuo and had no qualms of harm befalling him. So without hesitation, he walked into the illusion array that would be able to isolate him and his omnipresence. As soon as he stepped across, it was as if he had crossed worlds. Jian Chen felt the scenery around him begin to distort as he discovered that he was now standing in a desert. The sun was beating down on him heavily with its harsh rays, and the fine sand beneath him had started to bake his feet. It was as if he was standing on a burning red piece of metal. "Master, this is all an illusion. The person behind this illusion had to rely on the power of the world to create it. Know that it's not real. Continue to walk forward slowly." King Xuo explained. Obeying her words, Jian Chen took a single step forward, another step, then a third step. Finally, on his fourth step, the sands beneath his feet began to swirl around before forming a vortex that threatened to devour him whole. "Quicksand." Jian Chen started. He subconsciously thought about using the energy of the world to force his way out before King Xuo and Zig suddenly cried out to him, "Master, don't fight it. Otherwise, you'll be transported to the outside by the power of the space gate." Zhang and King Xuo spoke at the same time. Hearing this, Jian Chen gave up any idea of resisting and allowed for the sand to submerge his body. It was pitch black underneath to the point where even Jian Chen couldn't tell east from west. He was better off with his eyes closed, since he wasn't able to distinguish anything. When he tried to use his omnipresence, he came to the realization that it was being forcibly suppressed, meaning he couldn't use it. Not too long after, Jian Chen felt himself finally stop descending through the ground. At the same time, his body was being pressed by something heavy. From this feeling, Jian Chen truly felt as if it were sand that was crushing him. "Master, take a step to your left or right." Jian Chen closed his eyes and turned himself at an angle before walking one step forward. This single step seemed as if it had taken him thousands of kilometers to a completely different place. Even with his eyes closed, Jian Chen could clearly feel a stinging light radiating from the sky and the fragrant smell of flowers wafting through the air. Opening his eyes, Jian Chen realized he was now in a spectacular garden that was almost impossible to describe with words. It was almost like a paradise with all sorts of sweet-smelling thing and a pool not too far away. The water in the lake was clear, and many fish could be seen swimming in it. "Master, walk forward." Jian Chen began to walk forward before finally stopping by the side of the lake. "Master, this is all fake. The things you are seeing are not real. There is no water in front of you. Continue to move forward." "What a magical illusion array. It seems completely real." Jian Chen sighed as he admired the illusionary's effects. Then, taking a step forward, he began to walk into the pool of water. When Jia Chen's foot touched the surface of the water, his body did not sink. It was almost as if he was floating. Jian Chen felt as if he were stepping on a thin piece of glass. Still following the sword spirit's instructions, Jian Chen continued to walk across the water until he arrived at the very center of the lake. Suddenly, the scenery around him began to spin and spin before the garden disappeared almost instantaneously, only to be replaced with a bottomless abyss right in front of Jian Chen's eyes. The world began to grow dim. There was no sun, and at the same time, there was no moonlight. It was as if he had stepped into the lands of hell, standing on the tip of the precipice. Right in front of him was an abyss with no bottom to be seen. Yet, a grotesque sound could be heard faintly, originating from down below. It was not unsimilar to a devil howling in a way that would terrify any listener. "Continue to walk forward," King Xiuo spoke inside Jian Chen's mind. After hearing him, Jian Chen continued to listen to the sword spirit's instructions through all the different types of worlds the illusion array threw at him. From time to time, he would walk forward through the areas, backward, or even having to move left or right. After being tormented endlessly for an hour, Jian Chen finally walked through the completely mysterious illusion array. After exiting the illusion array, Jian Chen found himself within the dark belly of the mountain. It was spacious all around him, with only a single wooden house to be seen in the desolate area. "Zhang, King Xiuo, there shouldn't be any more illusions, correct?" Jian Chen asked the sword spirits. The illusions had felt all too real to him, to the point where Jian Chen could no longer distinguish between reality and illusions. This caused Jian Chen to doubt whether or not he was in reality. "Master, we've exited from the illusion array. Whatever you see in front of you is real," Zhang spoke. Zhang's reply caused Jian Chen to relax and immediately revealed a smile on his face. After being thrown side to side for so long, he had finally arrived at his final destination. Quelling his excitement, Jian Chen stepped closer and closer to the wooden house in front of him. Just as Jian Chen exited from the illusion array, in the valley overhead, five bright lights could be seen flying toward the valley at an extremely fast speed. Finally, they came to a stop above the valley and looked down below. Among the five, there were four elders and a middle-aged man. Each one wore a different color robe and had serious expressions on their faces. They also had a strong amount of power flicker off of their bodies. According to what that Heaven Saint Master from the Kai'angan Kingdom said, the Saint Ruler's cave should be located here, 50 meters away from a precipice in a valley. "This is the place," the middle-aged man spoke as he looked down. "There's no differences between this place and the information we heard. This must be it. Let's go down and hope that the Heaven Saint Master wasn't lying to us," the elder spoke calmly. "Haha, Elder Feng, you think too much. That Heaven Saint Master holds a special position within the Kai'angan Kingdom and was the king of the previous times. He wouldn't dare lie to us. Otherwise, he wouldn't be able to handle the consequences. Besides, he did not tell our Huang family this secret without conditions," another elder laughed.